Zero or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports talks on ending a deadlock between Greece and its international creditors broke up in failure on Sunday, with European leaders venting their frustration as Athens stumbled closer towards a debt default that threatens its future in the euro. European Union officials blame the collapse on Athens, saying it had failed to offer anything new to secure the funding it needs to repay 1.6 billion euros to the International Monetary Fund by the end of the month. Greece retorted it was still ready to talk, but that EU and IMF officials had said they were not authorized to negotiate any further. Someone close to the talk said, "This is very disappointing and sad. It was the last attempt to bridge our differences, but the gap is too large. One can discuss a gap, but this is an ocean." Both sides acknowledged that the talks lasted less than an hour, although even here accounts differed. Greece put the length at 45 minutes. EU officials put it at half an hour. Last Friday, Greek Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras had indicated he would accept painful compromises on demands for austerity and reform in return for debt relief. But the Commission said after the talks, which also involved the European Central Bank, that the Greek proposal remains incomplete. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
As Sao Paulo struggled to dig out after last week's devastating earthquake,
I'm just praying and helping.
One group was left with no one to care for them.
There is nowhere for these homeless dogs to go. There is no food to give them. There is no clean water. These dogs are going to starve to death.
I have to do the humane thing. I have to put these dogs down.
O'Brady Shaw is the only journalist compassionate enough to do what has to be done.
Put down 50 or 60 dogs today? I didn't want to.
Let me help you!
But their fate would have been much worse if I hadn't have done it.
It's better this way.
O'Brady Shaw goes where other reporters won't and does the jobs other reporters can't.
I'm so sorry.
Gut Check with O'Brady Shaw. Live from Sao Paulo, tomorrow night, only on the Onion News Network.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. As we count down the days to the Porcupine Freedom Festival, it's already getting exciting up here in New Hampshire as people are going to be likely coming into the state throughout the week and touring around. It's an excuse to kind of get around and see the rest of New Hampshire before on Sunday the kickoff of the Porcupine Freedom Festival begins. It's a week-long camping festival that happens in the northern portion of New Hampshire, and right up in the nestled in the White Mountains in a little town called Lancaster at a place called Rogers Campground. We've been doing this for several years. I'm excited about this. I'm already getting the equipment packed up and testing it, making sure everything works before we get up there, because it's pretty rustic. I mean, as far as all things, I guess it's not rustic. There's like a hotel on the campsite. But as far as internet access, it can be a real challenge to get any kind of internet access.
I hear there's going to be better internet this year.
There was better internet last year, and I expect it will be improved upon.
And this year, there's new showers.
There are additional showers.
Additional
actually.
Showers, yeah.
So the campsite has its own showers, and then somebody's bringing in a shower truck, some sort of like a camper size unit, like an RV size thing that's just full of showers, I guess.
So because, cool.
Yeah, I think it's cool innovation. So we'll see what other innovations there are as the week rolls on. Right now, the Porkfest group, that's the Porcupine Freedom Festival, PORCFEST group on Facebook is bustling. There are all kinds of people posting questions and, you know, looking for rides and, you know, ride shares to come up here to New Hampshire. So it's very exciting. Good times. Go to porkfest.com. It's not too late for you to get involved. We're going to be broadcasting live throughout the week there next week at Rogers Campground. With you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
And, of course, you can join us via Skype.
I swear you should do jazz hands whenever you do that.
Skype username here is lrn.fm. Mark, you were offended tonight by a video that I posted on the Free Talk Live Facebook and Twitter. And it is a flag-burning video where multiple U.S. flags are set ablaze Manchester activists in a video that was released today in celebration of Flag Day yesterday.
Oh, my.
Yeah, so it is actually not the first time that activists in New Hampshire have set the U.S. flag ablaze.
Much to my chagrin.
There was, of course, the Anarcho-Jesse event that happened several years ago here in Keene's Central Square.
Which I believe if you search flag burning on Google, mm-hmm. that image comes up first.
It does it now?
Right there in beautiful downtown Keene, New Hampshire.
Well,
you know,
I know it was passed around a lot. Well, it does not come up first on mine. It comes up fourth, but it's still in the top five, which
is
pretty
good. That's a beautiful
good.
Image.
Yeah, there's, yeah, yeah, it's really
that's
good.
That's really nice. You know, when I think of flag burnings, I think, you know, destruction, and they're negative. They have a negative image in my mind. Like, mm-hmm. Burning anything. Why would you burn anything out in public, you know? But unless it looks pretty, which this photograph does. So apparently this was Jesse and Keene.
Yeah, yeah, by the way, nice. that it's both the fourth and the second picture. The second picture, if you zoom in on a little bit.
Oh, you're right. That is from Keene.
Yeah,
oh.
Absolutely. So we have the
That's not a very good one, though, that second one.
Ignominious title here.
There's not enough flame on the flag in the, yeah. in the second one.
Ground zero for the good flag burning pictures. I'm just...
You know, it's really interesting that that has happened, right? Because the video of Anarcho-Jesse burning the flag has not really gone anywhere spectacular. I think last time I looked, which was within the last few months, it was at around 9,000 views.
Okay.
And the picture, however, has been turned into a meme. So all these flag waver types have made memes out of the Anarcho-Jesse still frame.
Something like, you're not edgy if you burn a flag, you're just an a-hole.
You're an a-hole. Yeah.
you know, this picture is...
And he may be an a-hole. I mean, I'm not necessarily
This is not famous. It is infamous, is really the definition of that.
But it really, I mean, on the scale of flag burnings, the original one that Anarcho-Jesse did was pretty good. I mean, he did set all three flags ablaze, which, of course, you don't see in the still photo.
No, you don't see people researching that, really, when they call somebody an a-hole on this.
Yeah.
And that's kind of my complaint here.
Well, there's all kinds of complaints about activism.
No,
You're not
no, my complaint's
complain
specific.
About it.
What is it?
Well, my complaint is you don't do things that can be used against you.
Well, that's ridiculous.
But anything could be used against you.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. Well, flag burning is a pretty easy layup that you're going to be called an a-hole.
They say the same things about toplessness and smoking pot.
There are all kinds of people do topless and pot-smoking activism. The only people who do flag burning activism are people with AK-47s in their hands that yell,
he does not
death
have
to
an
America!
AK-47.
No, no.
Besides this picture.
I'm a little bit with you, Mark, in like one nuanced respect. It has to be done well. Like, this is a beautiful photograph. I can see people fumbling with burning flags and it looking like a mess. You know, you have to know what you're doing if you're going to do it.
Okay, I will agree the composition on this photo is good,
right.
But that is in and of itself not a good thing.
That's not enough.
You see, good composition on a photo of a Free State Project activist burning a flag in downtown Keene, New Hampshire is a bad thing because it's good composition, right? This photo is
Nazi-
going...
What if it were a Nazi flag? Would that be okay because you can burn them because we don't like them?
You can
or
burn
is it any
all
flag?
The Nazi flags you want. You but, can
so
burn...
it's not the fact that it is a flag.
No,
you're
it,
not against flag burning
I am not.
Per se.
He has actually participated in flag burning
Which
of
ones?
The UN flag.
No.
Yep.
Don't you think that'll upset people,
hey.
Mark?
Yeah, absolutely. It'll upset some people, but not the people that matter. You see,
why do the people who would get upset by a flag burning matter?
Okay, so what do you want this painted this way? Do you want the Free State Project coupled with the idea of flag burning?
I don't care.
I know.
There
that's
are Free
the
State
problem.
Project what participants. Excuse me, Mark. There are Free State Project participants who are burning the flag. That is something that is activism. And
no,
so
that
if
is
they
not
want,
activism.
If they want,
if you're doing your activism while sitting down, it is by the definition inactivism.
Oh, get real, because you have claimed you're an activist because you sell ads for Free Talk Live. And
all
I'm pretty
day,
sure you're seated.
Every day.
I'm pretty sure you're sitting down when you're on the phone most of the damn time.
Yeah.
Most of the time.
So are you rescinding your own activist
This
cred?
Is not activism. This is not going to be interpreted as anything but juvenile. I don't know what to tell you.
What do you,
you
think is the worst that's going to happen if the Free State Project participants are painted in this light? What's the worst thing?
Lynchings.
Do you think that there are people who sign up for the Free State Project or might sign up for the Free State Project that still consider themselves to be somewhat patriotic?
Yeah.
Okay.
Lots.
Do you think that those people are not valuable?
No, right, and I see your point where you're going is they're probably turned off by photographs like this.
Highly turned off by the photographs like this. This is a religious icon to people. This is tantamount to drawing Muhammad in front of Muslims, okay? That's what this is. I'm not saying...
I don't know if all Muslims are offended by drawing Muhammad, are they?
they're not going to be happy about it. Yeah. I just heard from a Muslim today that's talking about it. He's not happy about it.
Happening in New Hampshire now. There's another Draw Muhammad Day happening.
I did hear
now.
About that, yeah.
Right, and the people who are doing it are a-holes.
Why?
Why are they a-holes?
Yeah.
You don't have to ask me. You don't do things that are sacrilegious for the sole purpose of doing sacrilegious things.
It's drawing a cartoon. Well, I like the fact that these things are slightly offensive, but when you look at them—
This is not slightly offensive. I'm all
I'd
for
like
slightly offensive.
I'd like to hear what
offensive.
He was going to say.
Yeah, but when you look at them objectively, you're like, nah, it's just a cloth. Why get so upset?
Wait, are we talking about human beings still? Because you just said objective. They don't do that crap. Human beings are not objective creatures.
Yeah. Well, then we should stop doing all activism because it might be misinterpreted by these unobjective people.
No, you should stop doing stupid activism.
Oh.
And you should stop promoting stupid activism.
So now name calling.
What else are you going to call it? Is it smart activism?
I think this is cute. You know, the video on the front page. Now, I'm talking about
the
what
video,
happened this
once you
week,
see the video, it gets a bit less offensive.
It's cute. They're burning little flags. They're these teeny little
flags. Oh, well, if it's
flags.
Little, it's okay.
Yeah, exactly. So there's a video up right now over at freekeen.com. And it's sort of in the tradition of various flag burnings, but it's different. I've never seen a video before where little tiny flags, like the size of a flag you'd put in a drink
kind.
Or something. Yeah, like on a toothpick. And so there's multiple activists in Manchester, including Shire Dude, who we've had on this program, as well as Cecilyn is there, who's one of our new co-hosts here on Free Talk Live. And of course, they bring out the token brown guy to actually participate
oh, no.
in this Riaz from Manchester. And it's basically two videos back to back of different Manchester activists mm-hmm. setting this tiny little American flag on fire. And I just think it's adorable and kind of fun.
How old's the video? Is it new today?
It's brand new. It actually was uploaded, I think, yesterday and then ultimately posted to the blog today.
Are people upset already in the comments section of the
They will
video?
Be soon.
There's a few so far, but I don't
this
think
is
it's
one,
really...
one square inch of flag we're talking about.
I don't really think that it has hit big yet, so the toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. You can tell us how you feel about flag burning as activism. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. You can take control of the airwaves here. This is Free Talk Live. Skype us at lrn.fm.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem?
problem, officer!
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. Mymagicmud.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, we are back. You may take control of the airwaves here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype on in here and join us at username lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio, you've got me, Ian, here.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
Hey, by the way, if you are on the internet at all, you are the one who is responsible for protecting yourself. There are different tools that you can use to help you with that, and ProXPN is a darn good one. You go to proxpn.com/FTL, and you download free software that will encrypt your data connection, meaning your internet service provider will no longer be able to know what you're doing with their internet service. So they're still providing you the internet service. It's just now you're encrypting your data, and so they're just passing along encrypted data, which also means that criminals who might want to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets will be foiled by ProXPN as well. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. Grab the software, Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux. Whatever operating system you're on, there's probably a ProXPN that's going to work for you. And once you get connected, you are protected. And then you can, of course, upgrade your account to premium level, where you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites, as well as you get a 7-day risk-free money-back guarantee at proxpn.com/FTL. So go get signed up there. Use code FTL50 when you're ready to upgrade, and you'll get the regular price. You get 50% off the regular monthly price when you get the annual account with code FTL50. It breaks down to around $5 a month. And that, by the way, is locked in for the lifetime of your account. So when you're ready to renew for another year, same great deal. Again, go to proxpn.com/FTL. Use promo code FTL50 and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. By the way, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. proxpn.com/FTL. Code FTL50. So we're talking about the video released today from Manchester activists, Shire Dude included here.
Happy New Year! From all of us to all of you.
They are setting a flag ablaze, and there's more than one that is set ablaze in this video, which sort of sets this video apart. Well, also, I guess Anarcho-Jesse set three flags on fire
at once?
Well, in the same setting, right? Like, so,
like one after another?
Yeah,
in succession.
In downtown Keene, he wanted to show support for abolishing all states, right?
Oh.
Like and true secession down to the individual. So he first burned a UN flag, mm-hmm. and then burned U.S. flag. He burned UN, U.S., and New Hampshire.
New Hampshire, yeah.
And I believe he burned them in that order. So I thought there was a real political statement there that was an excellent one. But of course, you're right, Mark, that it does get lost, obviously, on somebody who just sees a snapshot of the image.
And right. The people that okay. So this is really important. This is you should learn from your mistakes in life.
Was it a mistake?
Yes, because now Jesse's picture is the center of many memes that say if you burn a flag, you're not edgy, you're an a-hole.
So wait, those memes wouldn't get made if the picture weren't there? Come on.
You said yourself that it was a well-composed picture, that it was great, and good memes are well-composed. So I'm sure that somebody would make another meme, but they wouldn't necessarily find, you know, one that is quite as captivating as that one. I mean, there's such thing as good pictures and bad pictures. All I'm saying is this isn't activism.
Yeah, it is. It absolutely is.
Then what's it achieve?
Activism is doing something with the intention of trying to change things.
Excellent. What's it achieve?
It doesn't matter whether the activism achieves something.
So it's ineffective
activism?
It could change
people's minds.
It
could get
when
a conversation started.
When was the last time you called somebody an a-hole and then managed to change their mind?
It's for fence-sitters. It's for people who are like not really thinking about the state every day. Like, yeah, there are some people who really love the government, but then there's most people who just don't even care or think about government most of the time. And then if they see an image like this, they'll be like, oh, I wonder why that is.
Those same people that were forced to pledge allegiance to that flag every single day at school. I'm sorry, this is just a bad idea. And yeah, I get it. It's something that people are doing while they're sitting around drinking. Oh, look, we bought 1,000 little toothpicks with American flag on the end. Let's set one on fire every holiday and make a video. I mean, that's fine, right? Like, they're having fun or whatever they're doing, but it isn't activism.
Shouldn't activism be fun? How dare you say that this is not activism?
Okay.
Who are you to decide whether or not this is activism?
Well, you know, you can smear yourself in peanut butter and run down the street naked yelling, screw the state, but it's not activism.
Well,
it's
I would
just
say
another
that is
dumb
activism.
Person.
I mean, that's, you know, you're doing something.
Well, it's
activism by definition is doing something,
that's,
right? Like, you know, physically, typically
okay,
doing
fine.
Something.
Okay, fine. We'll call it counterproductive activism. Can we agree on that?
Well, I mean, the whole peanut butter thing is a little weird, but I don't see anything wrong with running down the street naked.
Yeah,
I mean,
and it might get a bunch of page views.
Yeah, but what's it achieve? I need to have some questions here. You're gonna have to tell me how this achieves something. The whole idea of let's do something when other people are doing nothing is flawed.
Well, I can't
because what
say
you need to do is something that is productive.
Well, and I mean, it just
I'm
depends
not,
on what you're trying to
This is people having fun, and that's fine if they're having fun.
It just depends,
but it
Mark.
Isn't worth it, promoting.
It depends on what you're trying to produce. In this case, if Shire Dude's
angry
video...
Angry patriots is what
Shire
you're trying
Dude's,
to produce.
They're already angry. If Shire video goes viral, and he gets 100,000, 2 million views... I mean, I don't know. I've never seen... You would think a good flag-burning video would go viral, mm-hmm. but it hasn't happened up here yet as far as
you
the,
have the best composed you have the best flag-burning video on the internet, and you can't get it to go viral because it doesn't have an Arab guy going halalala and firing an AK-47 in the air.
Jesse's video is too long, I think, to go viral. It's more of a political statement. This one's very short. This one is less than a minute long, and so it's got that potential of virality. Whether or not it actually will is up to the internet,
okay.
obviously. But that could, you know, you just want to talk. You were asking, what does it produce? If it produces 100,000 or 50,000 or 500,000 views, then that could produce some revenue for Shire Dude. And further, you know, there may be some people. I've never had, to be fair, I've never had anyone say, you know, I really wanted to move to New Hampshire because of that flag burning video. But there are certain videos that we create up here that have a certain attitude, kind of a zeitgeist of what's going on up here. That is definitely attractive to a certain type of person, the kind of person who appreciates that level of activism, the risk involved in that. Because Jesse was at risk of being attacked by somebody in downtown Keene,
mm-hmm.
and so he took a lot of personal risk at that. I don't know, Derrick J., what do you think? Would this?
Well, part of what I like about flag burning is the aesthetic, but I could see how some people would view it as angry. Like, mm-hmm. oh, that person must be angry, even if they're not, you know?
Have been angry, but these people in this video are definitely not. This is a
laughing.
Fun video.
But I'm trying to think of some peaceful alternatives to flag burning that might be a little more creative. What about burying a flag? What about, you know, making little gravestones for the state? And
Didn't they do that one a
long
time ago?
And burying the flags. Or
didn't they bury Abraham Lincoln or something like that?
No, they hung Abraham Lincoln in effigy.
Okay. What about, you know, making state flag cakes and letting animals eat them or something? Like, here, you're just going to eat the state. Or, you know, get a little more creative than just burning. We've been doing that for thousands of years.
Well, Chris Cantwell did shoot the flag.
People,
right? That's new.
Yeah, people are right now with the flag being, you know, stomped on and that stuff. They're all whipped up, and emotional people tend not to spend time thinking. It's very difficult to take a person who's very angry and move them towards, well, let's talk about this for a second. I know that a very closely held icon of yours has just been sullied in your imagination, and you're worried about the upset of all the dead soldiers that have come in the past. And I get that you're upset about those things, but what we really need to think about is how that this flags have been used for you know, millennia to march innocent people off to war against other people, and the really war banners. No.
Good points, Mark. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Your thoughts?
A-holery.
On flag burning. You can watch the video right now at freekeen.com. There's more coming up. Free Talk Live.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Hey, I'm Ian Freeman, one of the hosts of Free Talk Live. I created Free Talk Live in 2002 as an alternative to traditional talk radio. I wanted a show where anyone could call in and bring up any topic without fear of being screened out. Combined with our libertarian, voluntarist viewpoints, Free Talk Live is a unique syndicated radio show heard on FM and AM radio stations, coast to coast and beyond. I moved from my birthplace of Florida to New Hampshire in 2006 as part of the Free State Project. I'm also the program director of LRN.FM, which I launched in 2009 to create a place to present the best liberty-oriented audio programs from around the globe. I perform liberty outreach of all sorts and have done civil disobedience, non-cooperation, and run for office multiple times. Much of that's covered on my blog at freekeen.com. Thank you for listening to our shows. And if you want to support our work, please visit amp.freetalklive.com and contribute just $5 a month to our effective liberty outreach. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, we're back with more. Of course, you can join us here, and you don't have to talk about setting the U.S. flag ablaze. You can bring up anything you want. In fact, we do have other things to talk about tonight, including a North Korean who actually walked across the DMZ to defect. Pretty brave individual, considering there are apparently landmines in that there DMZ. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-453. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
And have you ever been a victim of electronic pickpocketing, or perhaps has someone you love been a victim of electronic pickpocketing? It's where a thief can pass nearby you with a scanner and read the data on RFID chips that may be in your credit or debit cards. The thief can then use that information to charge your card for their purchases and perhaps even compromise your identity. Thanks to ID Stronghold, there is now an easy way to prevent electronic pickpocketing from happening to you. ID Stronghold has been making products to block electronic pickpocketing since 2005, and some of their most loyal customers are military personnel that place a high value on personal security. Now you can also have that same protection in the form of great leather RFID blocking wallets made by ID Stronghold. That's right. All you need to do is switch your wallet for a quality leather wallet from ID Stronghold with built-in protection against electronic pickpocketing. I like mine. Visit IDStronghold.com to see their huge selection of his and hers wallets. IDStronghold.com. Tell them Ian Freeman sent you. Let's go to John. He's in New York. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick J., and Mark.
Hi. I just wanted to say, I think Mark's on really on point here. I think the phrase, the way to phrase it would be, you know, you can be 100% correct about something and still lose the argument in the way in which you present it. I think specifically when it comes to the Free State Project and libertarianism, we need as many people as possible. We're definitely a minority. And I think the thing you need to worry about more is sort of galvanization. And what I mean by that is not so much offending people, but you could take someone who, you know, someone who's sort of a traditional neocon, and if you phrase it the right way, you can push him not all the way, but maybe a couple steps. And I view it as sort of a win. You know, the example I'll use is I was talking to somebody who's, you know, really big. We got to get over there, and the way I phrase it is, look, why should, you know, people in this country, if they're not willing to fight over there, send our troops? You know, I could have totally turned him off by just, you know, bringing up some flag burning thing, and he would maybe say, well, libertarianism is just not for me. But by phrasing it in a different way, I may have planted a seed that 3 years from now may bring him, you know, to do something like join the Free State Project. Whereas maybe a flag burning thing might, you know, that might set the tone for good for them. They might just, well, I'm galvanized. I'm set. I'm not into that at all.
Yeah, galvanizing, what you mean is sort of causing people to dig their heels in on a particular position.
Exactly.
And in many cases, the people that would be the most upset are dug in pretty thoroughly already. Mm-hmm. But that doesn't change the fact that, you know, everybody, you have to, if you're going to present an idea, you have to believe that everybody has an opportunity to believe that idea. And so, therefore, if you're going to convince people of things, the first thing you don't do is spit in their eye and then try to convince them that it was a good idea.
Yeah, I think the example I'll bring up is really what I've been watching in the past, you know, maybe 2-3 years, is the feminism movement as an example of what not to do. I think there's even from very radical feminists, I think there's a lot of ideas that have a lot of validity to them, but they have to be phrased in the right way. So at this point, you know, the Tumblr people, I mean, just sort of the very rabid, the way that they'll go to conventions and just sort of, you know, do loud horns over the, like, you've galvanized somebody who maybe would have listened and said, okay, there's a little bit of validity to that, and you planted a seed. Now they're like, well, I'm never listening to anybody who has anything to do with feminism again, and they've actually ruined what other, you know, feminists had to say, because that's it. You set the standard.
That's how it was for me. I looked into feminism with the intention of, look, I believe I like new ideas. I want to find out new ideas. Surely women have been treated poorly in the past, and there has to be something that these people are talking about that is of value. However, the conclusion I have come to is that feminism, if there is still a philosophy of value in there, is so completely overrun with man-hating trolls that it is of no value. And I think that what you're saying here is that if we do not present ourselves properly, we're going to look like a bunch of America. I mean, people are out there already talking about America hating like it's a thing. Like people actually hate America. Ian, do you hate America?
I don't even know what that really means.
Exactly. And burning a flag doesn't help you to talk about what you mean.
Well, it might, actually. It might get a conversation started.
It wouldn't.
I mean, it certainly has
gotten
a conversation started.
I hate you. You're stupid. Now go. Tell me.
Well, those are the kind of people I don't want to talk to. I mean, there are a lot of people out there who are really angry, and they don't like change, and they like to lash out with insults and you know, property destruction and attacking people physically because those people have done things that they don't like. And there's always something that somebody doesn't like. I mean, if you do enough activism, you get out there often enough, you're going to upset somebody. And so there have been things like, you know, like the topless event that happened here with a young lady open carrying topless. And then there was Topless Tuesdays a couple of years later that lasted for a couple of weeks and went away. People remember that kind of stuff, and for some people, they love it. For others, they absolutely hate it. Should we be second-guessing ourselves so much, John, in New York, that we second-guess ourselves into inaction?
No, and what I'll say, though, ultimately, is I think you have to approach it from different ways. I think the Christopher Cantwells, I think they have a place in the movement. There are certain people that just love what he does in response to it. Mm-hmm. I don't think for the vast majority of people, that he is going to do, he's going to do more galvanizing with the vast majority of people. Now, ultimately, I think he does need to be there because there's certain people who would only respond to him. But ultimately, when it comes down to it, I think you need to remember that you need numbers. I really think that libertarianism, we're in the minority. The Free State Project, I think, is the best solution, and I think you need it. It's not watering down your message to tread lightly, if it were. You know, if sort of the middle average citizen is going to get turned off by something like a flag burning, maybe don't promote it as much. I'm not saying don't do it because there's people who are going to see that and say, you know what, I'm tired of that. But I think you need sort of the average person too, because ultimately you want as many people to take a step forward.
Thanks, John, for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you.
What John said here, and this is bad. I wish I would have come up with it. What he said is that everybody's got their role. The Cantwells of the world have their, the Christopher Cantwell, former Free Talk Live co-host. His role is to talk to the base, to try to mold the philosophy of the already existent libertarian base. That is not Free Talk Live's role. That is not the role of a nationally syndicated radio program that airs on a general audience's radios. What our role is to preach the message of liberty and to bring people in. And my claim to you is this is a terrible way to bring people in, because not only does it turn off the people who are upset about flag burning, because certainly it would.
Well, what makes you think I'm using this to try to bring people in? I mean, I'm posting this at freekeen.com.
No, you posted it at FreeTalkLive.
Actually, it was Shire Dude who posted it at freekeen.com. Yep. That's because our listenership is mostly libertarians, at least the core.
Our Facebook page is not mostly libertarians. Yeah. It's people who've seen
memes. Is it going to get people tuning in? That's all I care about. Is it going to get people paying attention? That's all that I care about.
I know it is. I know it's what you care about.
Is it going to get people upset, maybe calling into the show? That's fine, too.
Let's take a look at
some controversy.
This is how your activism has worked in Keene, New Hampshire. The vast majority of people here, when they think of free Keene,
the vast majority,
hate you.
Have you done a poll? Have you done a scientific poll?
I paid for a poll. I didn't do it. No, it's not a scientific poll because
didn't.
It's hard to. Yes,
that's
I did.
Right.
I paid for a poll.
No, you did not do a scientific poll.
I did a poll. I had an article written up. I paid $40 to a man who did a poll to write up an article on it, and he said your brand recognition is 97% negative.
Wait a minute. You're talking about the guy who went down to a couple bars on a Friday night in Keene and talked to some drunks in town and asked them what they thought about the activists in town? That is not anything even worth reporting, Mark. It's nothing but anecdotal and it's meaningless.
I don't know how it's anecdotal when you talk to more than 100 people.
I talked about that to a local person and he laughed about the bars that individual went to. And you know, he said that of course that's what's going
to
happen.
I don't know what to tell you, man. You asked me if I did a poll. Yeah. I answered your question.
I've actually been on the streets and actually talked to people who were not S-faced.
Talk about anecdotal when people report to you.
I've talked to hundreds of people on the streets.
Yes, I hear you, but it's still anecdotal because they're talking to you.
Of course it's anecdotal.
Hey,
but it's just as anecdotal.
I'm an a-hole? No, it is not just as anecdotal.
It's even better because I had hundreds of people I talked to instead of just a few people at a bar who were S-faced.
I know what your activism looks like. I live here.
Toll-free number is 855-453.
I have to explain
Derrick
J., to people.
Are you hated when you're on the streets in Keene, New Hampshire?
Sometimes, yeah.
But more often than
he
not?
He won't give this up.
It's
people hate
live.
You, dude.
More coming. It's fine. I accept that.
You want
That's
it.
What happens when you're an activist. No, I don't, really. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lawns to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin and stays strong for 24 hours. New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Among OTC oral antihistamines, refers to first dose only. Starts working in 1 hour. Use only as directed. Visit Allegra.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you'd like. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about flag burning. It's happened again up here in New Hampshire, now spreading to Manchester, with multiple Manchester activists being photographed setting U.S. flags ablaze, being video recorded. The video's up right now if you want to go see it over at freekeen.com. It's less than a minute long, so it's easy to share. It's easy to watch. And, well, some people will say it's not easy to watch. They'll say it's upsetting, it's angering, and Mark is getting upset and angry on their behalf here tonight.
Wait, I don't think I'm that upset or angry.
Oh, really? You were shouting earlier, so it sounded
you
like
shouting
you,
too?
You might have been. Yeah, well, that's generally what happens when someone shouts. You know, usually voices get raised in that case. And you were asking if I want to be hated. And, of course, you know, who wants to be hated? It's just that I understand that I will be hated because by virtue of the fact that I am an activist. And we're going to go on with your phone calls here in a moment, but Derrick J., you said that you got some hate recently in downtown Keene, but I don't think you explained what happened on the air. It had something to do with your umbrella?
Oh, yeah. It was just recently. This morning, I was going to get some coffee at a local coffee shop, and there was a man who I had been threatened by in the past in downtown Central Square. He brandished a gun at me and a few others who were doing some chalks.
So this isn't your average person downtown. This is somebody who is vehemently already against you. Now, do you think
he knows me, he doesn't like me, and yeah. So I was walking by with my pretty pink umbrella and, you know, singing my song. And yeah, he pointed, and a few of his friends, he was standing with like four others, you know, like biker gang types,
sure.
You know,
tough
with the
guy.
Leather jackets, yeah, right. Hanging out by coffee shops. Whatever,
and he does but. Ride a motorbike, I believe.
This yeah, is so, you know, he pointed and they all turned around and laughed a little bit. But I had my earbuds in and right. I'm on my mission to get coffee. I don't need to worry about what they're thinking or laughing about.
But I mean, this is an outlier, right? This doesn't happen to you on a regular basis, right? No, you're going downtown for some coffee. Are
no.
people.
Did anybody, like, say, drive by your house with a blowhorn yesterday saying, you know, like,
yeah,
leave?
That happened.
You're an a-hole.
Yeah, that happens, Mark. Welcome to activism. Let's go to Ron. He's in North Carolina.
Happen all the time.
You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, you guys. Can you hear me, dude? All right.
You're kind of a little muffled. I don't know if you're on like a speakerphone or a headset or something like that.
Yeah, I don't know. This thing kind of mixed up a little bit. Is that any better?
Not really, but we can hear you. Go ahead.
All right. Okay. I guess you know you think of it as activism. To me, activism can mean a lot of different things. I mean, it can
sure.
be just like raising the level of awareness of certain things, you know?
Absolutely.
And I guess if, you know, you guys, the Free State Movement and whatnot, can certainly use some publicity, you know, get the word out a little bit more. And, you know, maybe this is the kind of thing where in the right set of circumstances could be something that would give you guys a lot of publicity.
It could. Now, obviously, a lot of people argue it's going to be negative publicity, but, you know, I feel like these kind of videos that can be seen as offensive will reach the right people. They'll reach the right individuals who are ready for the message of the Free State Project and are of the mindset that, you know, are willing to take a risk. Those are the kind of people
okay,
that I
so
like
with,
coming
with
here.
With that said, turn it up a notch. They have a little flag, you know, on a little pole and a pile of Korans at the bottom. Like those Korans on fire. And as those flames are reaching up, you know, they're going to catch the American flag on fire.
Yeah, I like the way you think. Have you made this video, sir?
Throw some Bibles on top of it. Really, really
no,
do
no,
it all.
No.
Piss everybody off.
Christians don't give a crap about that. But I mean, I'm serious. I mean, that's what freedom is about. You know, you're free to burn the flag. You're free to burn the Koran. And any of these Muslims, you're going to get upset about it. Say, hey, we're burning the flag, too. This is what freedom is, you moron.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know. It's just a thought.
Yeah, but well, I think the flags, the burning part looks so angry. I mean, we've got to get past this and start putting flags in jello molds or blocks of ice. Do something else.
Well, Ian really just wants to be martyred for the cause. I mean, he's just hoping that somebody comes along and kills him. And that way, finally, we can
say that. I mean, that's really sick.
Because it's pretty obvious you like to do it. You'd like to get up people upset.
Come down here to North Carolina, go down like to Camp Lejeune and burn some flags. If you want to be martyred.
Thanks, Ron, for your call tonight. I appreciate it. You know, I'm not interested in setting other religious icons on fire. I mean, if somebody else wants to do that, that's certainly their business. And I've never actually done a U.S. flag burn myself.
You just support them.
But I don't oppose it, and I am willing to put it up on freekeen.com. In this case, it was Shire Dude who posted the video. But, you know, I feel like the U.S. flag symbolizes tyranny. It symbolizes world oppression. It symbolizes oppression here at home.
Flags. And, flags and symbolize war. That. The fact is the U.S. flag.
It's the worst of all, in fact, because the U.S. government is the biggest, most oppressive country in the entire planet.
Well, I can tell you, why don't you just, they're biggest, but I mean, you know, move to North Korea. They are still most in the oppressive. Top 20 freest countries on the planet.
Yeah, and you try telling that to the people they're bombing over in Afghanistan and wherever else.
Let them put out some videos of flag burning, and that will have a much better reception than some guy who's living in a relatively good lifestyle in Keene, New Hampshire.
This was in Manchester, actually.
This is so awful. These aren't really flags, Ian.
What? You don't think this is going to offend people?
I think it'll offend some people.
Well, why
yeah.
would it not be a real flag? It's just a small flag. They're little, tiny little flags.
I think the point of this video is to bait those who would be upset about a regular flag burning and then laugh at those people because they're upset about toothpicks.
Yeah,
that's what it's about. It's a bait and switch.
I want to convince people of things, not to bait people and make them look stupid. You're stupid, stupid redneck flag waver.
All right, so people spend their time differently.
Yeah,
I mean,
how did that feel on the street today when you got treated badly for a pink umbrella and those sort of things?
No, I kept my chin up and I kept on walking.
Well, why didn't you change your mind? I mean, for God's sake, this person must have some good point.
Maybe Derrick should have just stayed in the closet, huh? Because he doesn't want to offend people.
Not
my claim. What people might think about his sexuality, and they might make fun of him, and it might make them uncomfortable. Maybe he should have just stayed in the closet.
No, I think you should readily explain what your problem is with the current setup of the nation state and the way that governments claim for themselves a monopoly privilege on the use of violence in a given landmass.
But wait, I thought you were against defending people.
What's that?
I thought you were against defending people. It's clear that Derek's homosexuality is offensive to
offending
some people.
People. Yeah.
So
yeah.
Shouldn't Derek have stayed in the closet?
No.
I mean, clearly people are upset. They're threatening him. They're making fun of him. They might even try to hurt him if you weren't carrying a gun, which you might be doing soon, from what I understand.
My claim is not that you shouldn't offend people. My claim is you should not purposely find the most effing offensive thing you can possibly do. Now, wait a second.
Okay.
When you were explaining to the guy previously what the value is of just doing something, anything for activism, all of your explanations could readily be as applied to, I should smear myself in dog feces and run down the road holding a sign that says, the state is full of S.
You don't
right?
think that's apples and oranges? Idea.
No, yeah. I don't. I think that there is bad activism out there.
I think
Ian
that would
will
be
even
bad.
Admit that there is bad activism.
I wouldn't support that, Mark.
Excellent. Yeah. We have found one piece of activism that Ian wouldn't support. By
it's
the way,
stinky.
There's the there's the libertarian cards against humanity, and what does one of them say, Derek J?
Oh, last night on Free Talk Live, Ian was saying that blank is a good form of activism.
Right, flag burning or dog feces or whatever it is. I mean, this is
I'd rather have more activism than less. Let's go to Mike. He's in Pennsylvania. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Mike.
Hello. Just wanted to point out where there's one time that's acceptable for burning the American flag, and that actually I found in a few places, U.S. flag code. Title 4, Chapter 1 states the flag, when it is in such condition that it is no longer a fitting emblem for display, should be destroyed in a dignified way, preferably by burning.
Isn't that interesting? I had heard that before as well, that it's actually...
That's the way you dispose of a flag,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, that's a little shocking.
And I would suggest, from an activist point of view, the thing to do is to hang the flag upside down.
That's also very offensive to people.
Which symbolizes that the country is in distress.
That's correct. But I would say that's almost as offensive.
No, that to me would
not be offensive to people.
But that would signify that I'm in distress. If I'm putting a flag upside down, I don't want to give a false alert to people that, like, I need help immediately. You know what I'm saying?
No, it just it signifies that the country is in distress, which it is at this point in time.
Well, I get where you're coming from. I don't oppose what you're talking about. In fact, Chris Cantwell actually reposted a video on his Facebook page that he made, I think it was in 2013, of him setting a flag on fire, and he's holding it upside down through most of it prior to actually setting it ablaze. But yeah, I see where you're coming from. But that also will be offensive. But then again, like I said, you know, to me, you have to do what feels most appropriate. Obviously, there are ways to adjust activism to make it more effective. But if people feel that they are compelled to set this awful symbol of tyranny ablaze in a visible manner, I can't say that's necessarily a bad thing. Just because some people are going to be upset about it, even if 51% of people are upset about it, I don't think you should be licking your finger and sticking up in the breeze.
Oh, I don't think it's 51%, dude. I think it's much higher than that.
Well, you don't really know, right? Like, you've never
taken
a poll.
I'm fine with 51%. If you can find 51%, do activism that only offends 51% and brings in 10%, that's great.
Mike, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. And you can share your thoughts. We don't have to talk. You certainly don't always have to talk about flag burning here. But if you've got more comments, you're welcome to join us. Also on the way here, since we're on the subject, five ways that powerful people trick you into hating protesters. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up in hour two next.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, ZOG.ninja, code FTL.
The Atlas Society's Atlas Summit is just around the corner, June 18th through the 21st, right before Porkfest in Nashua, New Hampshire. Connect, grow, have fun with longtime objectivists and people just learning Ayn Rand's philosophy. There are discounts for students, locals, and one-day rates at atlassociety.org. The event is jam-packed with speakers. Come and be a part of the most important objectivist event of the year, the Atlas Summit, June 18th through the 21st, Nashua, New Hampshire, Atlas Society. 20% off with coupon code FTL, atlassociety.org.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, June 15th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.97 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,180 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $236. Antiwar.com reports Kurdish YPG forces are advancing this weekend against the Islamic State-held town of Tel Abyad, a primary route for the Islamic State capital of Raqqa to the Turkish border, and are threatening to cut off the key supply route for the Islamists. YPG officials are confirming coordination with the U.S. military on the attack and several airstrikes carried out against the Islamic State forces in the town, the number of which is said to be growing as civilians flee the area towards the Turkish border. Islamic State still controls the town and the border road, but Kurdish officials say they believe it is only a matter of time before they take the area, a move which itself threatens to fuel more Turkish anger about U.S. government's close alliance with Kurdish forces in Syria. Turkey has complained that the U.S. is allied with Kurdish factions like the YPG, which are considered terrorist groups in Turkey, and fears Kurdish growth along its border threatens to ignite a new secessionist war among Kurds inside Turkey. If nothing else, it is saddling the region with tens of thousands of new Arab refugees, as the Kurds are accused of chasing the Arabs out of the regions liberated from the Islamic State. Given how important Tel Abyad is to the Islamic State, it is unthinkable that the town will fall easily to the YPG advance, and even with U.S. air support, this is likely to be a protracted battle for control over the border crossing, one which the Islamic State will bring as many fighters as necessary to hold. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports representatives of the United States and Venezuela met in a high-profile summit in Haiti over the weekend to mend diplomatic ties. According to media reports, Thomas Shannon, a counselor to the U.S. Secretary of State, met with Chairman of Venezuela's National Assembly, Diosdado Cabello, on Saturday. The meeting lasted for about 90 minutes and was facilitated by the Haitian president. It was not immediately disclosed whether any progress was made or how much during the summit. Word of the summit was revealed on Twitter, where Venezuelan officials addressed the meet and said the efforts there were aimed at thawing the nation's icy approach to one another. Earlier this year, Venezuela accused the United States of plotting a coup to overthrow President Nicolas Maduro. In turn, Washington labeled the South American Republic a security threat. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports talks on ending a deadlock between Greece and its international creditors broke up in failure on Sunday, with European leaders venting their frustration as Athens stumbled closer towards a debt default that threatens its future in the euro. European Union officials blamed the collapse on Athens, saying it had failed to offer anything new to secure the funding it needs to repay 1.6 billion euros to the International Monetary Fund by the end of the month. Greece retorted it was still ready to talk, but that EU and IMF officials had said they were not authorized to negotiate any further. Someone close to the talk said, "This is very disappointing and sad. It was the last attempt to bridge our differences, but the gap is too large. One can discuss a gap, but this is an ocean." Both sides acknowledged that the talks lasted less than an hour, although even here accounts differed. Greece put the length at 45 minutes, EU officials put it at half an hour. Last Friday, Greek Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras had indicated he would accept painful compromises on demands for austerity and reform in return for debt relief. But the Commission said after the talks, which also involved the European Central Bank, that the Greek proposal remains incomplete. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Retail giant CVS is gearing up for floods of customers seeking the perfect meaningless piece of crap for their office gift swap. The company is making no secret that when it comes to wasting the obligatory $20 on a useless electronic dartboard or pretzel maker for someone you couldn't care less about, CVS is your best option.
Our incredible selection of worthless shit is just the thing that nobody wants. We guarantee you'll find nothing personal or unique in our store.
The company is offering massive discounts on otherwise unsellable items for holiday parties you don't even want to go to, like the $12 decorative lantern, which is expected to be a big hit with customers who grab the first thing they see when they walk in the store.
I really wanted to get something that said, "I don't care about any of you people and I didn't put any effort into this."
CVS also has shitty Hanukkah gifts for coworkers who you think might be Jewish, like candles and those little plastic net bags full of chocolate money.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. 855-450-3733. Mark is getting all whipped up over this flag-burning video that has been posted on freekeen.com by Shire Dude. He's one of the newest bloggers over to Freekeen. He moved to New Hampshire about a year ago, just over a year, I would say, ago at this point, and has made a splash in the independent media circle. I think he's sort of really one of the real premier media producers out in Manchester. Of course, he's one of the co-hosts of the Rebel Love Show, which you've been on, I think, more than once, Derrick J.
Yes.
Great show. And ShireDude.com is his website. He put together a video of some activists out there setting the U.S. flag ablaze. And it's a little different from your typical flag-burning video. Not that there are a whole lot of flag-burning videos out there from the United States, But there's it's different because it's not angry. They're having fun while they're doing it. Whereas, you know, your typical flag burning video, as Mark pointed out earlier, is there's usually somebody shouting something either in a foreign language or shouting in general in the background, or the flag burner himself or herself is shouting something.
They're angry. This isn't angry.
This is not angry at all. It's fun, actually. And it's cute because they're burning little flags. Little flags. But yet Mark is still upset. He says this is offensive and we need to not offend people, or at least not offend a bunch of people with activism. Is that pretty much what you were saying last hour?
I'd say, you know, target your activism, you know, do a good job of, you know, not offending people for the sake of offending them. And I just haven't seen anybody ever be sort of convinced by, you know, what really brought me to the ideas of freedom? Somebody burning toothpicks with little American flags stuck to the bottom.
I don't think that's intended to bring people to the ideas of freedom. See, this is a common mistake.
Hold on. You have taken my position, as usual, and refocused it in the worst possible way. I didn't actually claim that there's a problem with his video. My claim is that there's a problem with
me promoting it,
posting it on Free Talk Live's Facebook page.
That's ridiculous. There are all kinds of offensive things that you and the other Facebook people post to the Free Talk Live Facebook
page. But we don't say U.S. flag set ablaze in Manchester, New Hampshire by Free State Project early movers, as though, whoopee! Finally, somebody in New Hampshire's set a flag on fire.
This is not the first time it's happened, but it's noteworthy because it's now spreading.
So now you can see that it didn't work the first time.
I don't know what you mean. It didn't work. See, this is the thing with the people who criticize like you do, Mark, is that, you know, you're constantly worried about what people will think or who we're targeting or whatever. And I feel like you put it out there. You have to kind of get in touch with yourself and what you really want. You put it out there as this is something that you think is important. This is something that is important to you. You're doing it. And people who see that, who are on the same page, are the ones that are the ones who are the target. They're the ones who are going to respond. The people who look at that video and they laugh are the ones, I think, who are the target of that video. I don't think that it's done to try to recruit John Q. Public into the Free State Project. I mean, Derrick J., what do you think?
I think it's kind of offensive to presume that people who are really, truly interested in the ideas of liberty and want liberty in their lifetime won't take a second glance at the Free State Project after seeing a video that they're offended by. I mean, it's just like, yes, this might offend some people, but if they're truly interested in liberty, I have faith that they will discover other videos that they're attracted to. You know, just because somebody sees a video that they don't like, I don't think of liberty as the same kind of product as like Tide laundry detergent. You know, it's not like, oh, I'm turned off by this once and I'm never going to go. I'm going to look for the many alternatives. You know, the ideas of liberty are going to be there forever. So,
and they're going to
appeal
to
people who are interested will find them.
Right. And they're going to appeal initially to a very small segment of the population.
Yeah.
And then hopefully, as more small, you know, that smaller segment becomes slowly larger, more of the average folks will start to fall on board with the liberty mindset, because it'll be popular, right?
Ian, have you found people that haven't signed up for the Free State Project that, you know, find a piece of activism on the internet that you've produced or you've seen somebody else produce and said, I'm not signing up because of this?
Oh, sure.
That happens all the time.
Yeah, it happens all the time. Okay. Have you found...
But we also have people who say, oh, I signed up because of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it wasn't flag burning. It was something else.
I'll give you that. No one's ever said that. But that's because flag burning is relatively inconsequential. I mean, as far as things
it's
go...
It's not inconsequential to the people that care about it.
You know, the videos don't really go
viral.
That's
the point I'm trying to make, is it's inconsequential to the people who... you're like, it's inconsequential to anybody who doesn't care about it.
Well, why do you
they're
think
unlikely
they're so
to be
great?
Convinced.
Why do you think these people are so great? The people who are turned off by flag burning videos. Why do you want them so bad? Why are you like, these people need to be in New Hampshire?
No,
you
know, I'm not claiming they need to be in New Hampshire.
Turning them away.
No, I would claim that you should not produce negative press for yourself when you can avoid it. That doesn't benefit you in really any way.
Depends on your
really
perspective, whether you consider this negative. I think this is a fun video.
Have you seen anyone? That's not fun is not positive.
What? Fun is not positive? What not, kind of a ridiculous, that's as ridiculous a statement as don't be courteous. Remember when the cops, I was out in front of the courthouse opening the door for people, and the cops literally came out and told me, don't be courteous. I shouldn't be opening the door for people. And so I opened the door for them when they came back into the courthouse and completely ignored what they were saying. That's as fun? What? People love fun. What's wrong with fun?
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. Nobody's going to come.
Hates fun.
Nobody's going to come to New Hampshire to drink and then set little toothpicks on fire. It's ridiculous.
How do you know they were drunk?
Has anyone ever signed up for the Free State Project and then seen some of your activism online and said, "I'm not moving even though I said I was going to"?
Sure, some wussy. Yeah. I'm sure there's been some mama's boy chickened out.
How many wussies need to chicken out because you have acted like an a-hole on the internet?
I don't really
care.
Who cares?
I know you
don't. These people are useless.
That's the point I'm trying to make here.
If they're afraid of moving to New Hampshire because something somebody did in Keene, New Hampshire, they're certainly not going to be any help against the state.
This happened in the heart of the Free State Project.
There's certainly not going to be any help against the people who are in the state.
Yeah, there are no trailblazers who are going to say, you know, I want to go and carve a new path to freedom in our lifetime, but oh my goodness, there's another person in the same geographic region doing stuff I don't like, so forget about that plan. Well, I mean, that is not
ridiculous.
I think there's a lot of people that have found other ways to go about finding liberty in their lifetimes besides the Free State Project.
Good
and
for them.
That Free State Project is in competition with these, and that you should therefore not give yourself negative
Those
advertising.
People aren't doing anything. They're just getting back on Facebook
Who
and
cares
bitching.
If they're, right, well, maybe they would have done something. You have no idea.
I don't care if whatever they
I didn't
would have
really
done.
Do anything for activism before I came here.
All I care about are the people who move. If there's a bunch of people out there who have a bunch of excuses as to why they
won't move
to New
Hampshire. Then give them reasons to move and stop giving them reasons not to.
They're the ones who have the reason not to. I'm just doing activism, and I'm supporting the activists here. I'm supporting the activists here who are doing good things and who are in touch with what they really want and who are true to themselves. That's what matters.
Yeah, what about giving a voice to people who want to make videos once they move here, like Ian is doing? You know, he's giving people an incentive to move here by giving them a platform to promote their material, like Shire Dude is.
Well, Shire Dude's got a platform. He's built quite a platform. He has a following, and
he's going to get more views through freekeen.com than he is
I'm not
through
complaining about freekeen.com. Freekeen.com is a S-storm disaster. I do not care
That's
whether
a ridiculous
Ian
statement. It's one of the most popular blogs in New Hampshire. It's one of the most popular libertarian websites in the world's top 50, I believe.
Mark doesn't like there. It.
No, and no, it's
by
an S-storm
all
disaster.
Indicators, yeah. By all indicators, Free Keene is an incredible success. You don't call it an S-storm disaster because some people in Keene, New Hampshire don't like us, or some people across New Hampshire don't like us. Of course some people don't like activism, Mark. It's activism. It stirs up their little world.
They're I'm not claiming like you shouldn't do work. Activism. Please stop refocusing
right.
that point.
We shouldn't do activism you don't like, right?
Absolutely.
Because some people don't like it.
Somebody with some sense should – I mean, somebody – here, if you don't have – sense, you should ask somebody with sense, hey, is it a good idea to post this video and for the purpose of getting people to move for the Free State Project? Because you've
good
posted
luck finding
here.
Unoffensive activism, Mark.
No,
good luck with
I like lots where of Mark is going here. You know, we should have a king of activism that we go to and we always ask.
We do. It's
Mark
Ian.
Edge.
Our
hey,
king
Mark,
is mad.
King Mark, can we do this activism? Will this be good?
Excellent.
Will people like it?
It's an excellent idea.
What if they don't like us, Mark?
That's exactly
what will
he's...
happen? Can we dethrone you if the activism you choose becomes unpopular?
Yeah, but you probably could.
Oh, well, then
it'd
what?
Be better than having
then
the current king,
be?
Which is Ian. And he'll go for anything. I mean, he's shown himself to
true.
Be a mad king
I
up to this point.
The poop smearing.
You have, it just,
he drew a line.
It exists in fantasy. You only oppose things that are in fantasy.
Yeah, you're being very hyperbolic and ridiculous right now, Mark Edge.
I'm not being hyperbolic or ridiculous.
But it would really blow up his ego a whole lot if that were the case. Maybe we should get him a little crown, activist king. 855-450-FREE. Mr. Know-It-All here with you tonight. He knows what's good. He knows what's bad. 855-450-FREE.
All I've claimed is to have some sense.
We've got
unlike
Skype.
You.
Skype username's lrn.fm. You can join us here. You can share your thoughts on flag burning and other things that are offensive. It's Free Talk Live. Also, join us via Skype again. LRN.FM is our username there.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%.
you'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
Are you a sneezer? If you're not, can you get close to one? I don't literally mean someone sneezing. Sneezer, as defined by marketing guru Seth Godin, is an opinion leader. When a sneezer mentions something, other people catch what Godin calls the idea virus. Seth Godin says some people are more likely to tell their friends about a great new idea. So identifying and courting sneezers is a key success factor for idea merchants. His book, Unleashing the Idea Virus, is the most downloaded ebook in history, and you can download the whole book free. That's how he's making his idea contagious. Click tips, tricks, and other stuff to help you cut through the clutter at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Should you be able to earn an honest living free from senseless government interference? The Institute for Justice thinks so. That's why we've spent years defending hard-working men and women from pointless government regulations. Nationwide, IJ has created opportunity by reducing government power. But there is still more work to be done. Visit our website today at ij.org. Let IJ take care of the government so you can take care of your business.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. And of course, you can join us here at 855-450-FREE. Since we're on the topic, we got five ways powerful people trick you into hating protesters. Although a lot of people don't need to be tricked. They just hate protesters. But we'll talk more about that here in a little bit. With you tonight, it's Ian.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
Derrick J's got himself a website. It's TheDerrickJ.com. What, Derrick J, will people find there right now?
The latest very un-PC episode of Freedom Fiends, in which MK Lords, Michael Dean, and Brett Vinat of the School Sucks podcast and I discuss words you're not allowed to say anymore in 2015. Really? Yep, but we said them anyway.
I saw that list. Was it 12 words or something like that?
12. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So
it was posted at the Free Talk Live.
I won't
Facebook
say them
page.
Here because I don't want to offend anybody. King Mark is sitting right next to me.
That's right. Mark actually is wearing his headphones in a very silly manner at the moment due to wearing a crown in the studio. I'm going to have to turn the camera
yeah,
back.
Yeah, you can
you
see
there,
it at cam.freetalklive.com in order to comment. I finally got the credit I deserve here.
You
I gotta
look
say.
really regal.
Yeah. And, you know, people in a different time, people would have understood my super geniusness. They would have seen my wisdom, and they would have really, they would have crowned me.
Now they can see it walking down the street.
Indeed.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts.
I may dress like this all the time. I kind of like having a crown.
That way you broadcast the message that I'm better than you.
Yeah.
Ken is in Nashua. Not Nashua, New Hampshire, but Nashua, Minnesota, listening to WNMT. Hey, Ken, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yes. On the flag burning thing there, if it offends the ignorant people, that'd be a good people to keep out of New Hampshire.
I agree.
Number one, I'll bet you the flags do not have gold trim. If you look at a police officer uniform, any courtroom or the flag behind the president has gold trim. That gold trim represents dictatorship.
Huh.
When they burn the flag without the gold trim, they're burning the symbol of real freedom. When they burn the flag with gold trim, they're burning the symbol of dictatorship.
I just checked. The flag in the video at freekeen.com does not have gold trim. So does that mean that you are now offended by this?
No, it just means that they're ignorant because they're burning the sign, the flag that actually represents freedom.
Gotcha.
Instead of the flag.
I guess it just depends, right? I mean, because different people have different opinions. That's one of the problems with a flag burn is that everybody who observes it, they're all coming from their perspective, and of course they're all different, right? Because some people say the flag to them means, like, you know, to me it's a symbol of tyranny. I don't really care whether it's got a gold fringe on it or not. That's how I feel about it. Other people feel like this is a symbol of freedom, no matter whether or not it has a gold fringe on it.
Ken, why would the president and the other people broadcast the message that they're dictators by using this flag?
That's what the gold fringe represents.
Yeah, but why would they do that?
All military flags are gold fringed. It's because you're under martial law.
Well, this is basically a conspiracy theory, Ken. I mean, let's just put it out there. This is something that you typically find with the courtroom theory movement, where they will claim that if you go into a courtroom and there's a flag with a yellow fringe on it, that means it's an admiralty jurisdiction, and then that means X, Y, and Z. But of course, when you actually try to challenge the jurisdiction, as Derrick J actually recently did in court, it really went nowhere fast. It was an entertaining video, though, which has been posted, I think, at thederrickj.com.
Yeah, right? And the cop threw everything out, and the judge decided, yep, I don't have jurisdiction. Sorry about your trouble. We'll reimburse you for your time.
Maybe in an alternate universe it happened that way, but no, they just went ahead and force-scheduled you for a trial. You were ready to plead guilty if they would just show the evidence that the laws apply to you, that jurisdiction actually applies to you, and they just brushed right over top of you and went ahead and scheduled a trial. So, Ken, thanks for the... Go ahead.
Sorry, Ken? Required his participation. In the book by Adam Rand, it's called The Fountainhead, the guy in there would not plead in a court case.
Yeah. It doesn't matter if you don't plead. They will put in...
their hands up and walked away.
Yeah, that's a book. In real life,
you've not pled a bunch of times, right?
I never plead, ever.
The last time I was in court, I didn't even speak, and they put in a plea of not guilty on that.
How many times have they incarcerated you when you don't plea?
I've been incarcerated a couple few times, three times.
That didn't work.
Hey, thanks, Ken, for your time tonight. I appreciate the call. I mean, I just, you know, I understand where he's coming from, and it's an interesting theory, but like all these legal theories, they really don't play out in reality, in my observation. So let's continue here. Let's jump into the story from cracked.com. These are the five ways powerful people trick you into hating protesters. Number five, wait for them to break the law. Wait for one of them to break the law, then talk only about that. This might literally be the oldest trick in the book. I'm thinking powerful people have been doing this to protesters and activists since the days when getting gored by a mammoth was a leading cause of death. It plays out like this. A certain group has a complaint. They're being discriminated against, had their benefits cut, whatever. But they are not the majority. B, because the majority is not affected, they are largely ignorant and uninterested in what is going on with the complainers. The news media does not cover their issue because it's bad for ratings. C, to get the majority's attention, the group with the complaint will gather in large numbers to chant and block traffic, etc. This forces the meter to... By the way, I oppose blocking traffic during protests. I think that's a real tacky move, and that is something that I, you know, that's
it
one of
It gets people's
things.
Attention.
That's the equivalent of, like, pulling on your mom's, like, shirt, and you're like, Mom, pay attention to me. I mean, it's like, okay, I'm doing something annoying that's getting in people's way, and they're going to pay attention to you. Yeah, I might get the results you want, but is that the way you want to do it?
This forces the media to cover the demonstration, since huge, loud groups of people make for good photos and video, and cover the issue in the process, since part of covering the protest involves explaining what's being protested. In America, we've seen this tactic used by everyone from impoverished war veterans to women seeking the right to vote to the protests about police violence you've been seeing all over the news recently. D. To counter this, all you need to do is simply wait for a member of the activist group, any member, to commit a crime. Then the media will focus on the crime, because riots and broken glass make for even more exciting photos and videos than the demonstrations. The majority, who fear crime and instability above all else, will then hopefully associate the movement with violence from then on. And further, I will add in to this discussion that frequently the crimes that are committed are actually committed by or at the behest of undercover police officers at some of these protests. I'm not saying
sometimes that's the case.
Right, I'm not saying it's always the case, but there have been a multitude of events where undercover cops wearing plain clothes have been essentially outed as police, who were down there essentially acting as agents provocateur, trying to provoke people into violence or actually starting some violence themselves in the hopes that others will follow them once they throw the first bottle, that kind of thing. So that's happened. Part E here to the description. You and your quest to keep the system from changing can now reframe the issue, you being the people in charge, can now reframe the issue not as oppressors versus the oppressed, but as citizens versus criminals. Supporting their cause means supporting violence. The TV will be full of images of burning convenience stores and looted storefronts, at which point the majority will then smirkingly say, I would never protest government oppression by mindlessly destroying someone's private property.
Are there other examples that apply to this besides Ferguson? Are you seeing this as an actual
template? In Baltimore.
Occupy Wall Street, I guess.
Baltimore's riots had that.
Right. I mean, okay, so this does actually happen in situations across the board. Then.
The larger the group, the more likely something like this will happen. I mean, the larger the group, the more likely you're going to be infiltrated by undercover provocateurs, and further, the more likely you'll attract just regular crazies who are willing to do stupid stuff like that. It even happened at the 420 celebrations at one point, where some kid apparently jumped out in front of an ambulance that was trying to get to wherever it was going, and that offended some of the cops. One of the cops who came and talked to me about it later, and I was like, dude, I don't know who that was. I didn't see it happen. It probably was not anyone I know. That's what happens when the public can show up somewhere.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
Did you say that you prostituted yourself when you were 10 years old?
I was doing something of a sexual nature in return
for... Was that a woman or a...
It was a next-door neighbor. He was probably around 16.
So he took advantage of you.
No, sir. He didn't take advantage of me.
He corrupted you morally.
No. No, sir. It was my choice to climb into his window. It was my choice, Lou. It was my choice to take my pants off and get into his bed. It was all my choice, Lou.
Listen to me, Ian. You do not have the right at the age of 10 to make that decision.
Don't you dare tell me what I can and can't
do,
Lou.
What do you mean, don't you dare? I'm telling you. He molested you.
No, Lou.
You don't even realize.
Sorry, Lou, you don't understand what molestation is. Molestation is unwanted sexual advances. I consented. I know you don't believe that's possible. I know me better than you know me, Lou.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Hey,
who do you think
you
are?
Excuse me. There is no video and audio allowed in
this office. No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait,
you gotta go.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared me.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derrick J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. Ian and Derrick and King Mark in the studio here tonight, looking very, very fancy in his crown. I don't know where you got that thing from, Derrick, but it's awfully elaborate.
Key invention.
Really?
Yep.
So we're going to continue here with the five ways powerful people trick you into hating protesters, but first,
Quantum Vibe, the liberty-themed epic science fiction webcomic story, has concluded. Volume 3 of the series will be available at the end of the month. It's the last day of June, but advanced autograph copies are going to be available directly from Big Head Press the Wednesday before that at the upcoming Porcupine Freedom Festival. You just stop by Site 27, like I'm going to, and get your signed edition. I don't expect them to last more than the day, but you might check back the next day if you haven't arrived yet. It's a Quantum Vibe. Now, Quantum Vibe Venus 23 has launched. It was June 8th was the first one. And it's an all-new story set in the same fictional universe with new characters and some familiar ones. You can check it out, quantumvibe.com. It is a liberty-themed science fiction story set in the relatively near future. Quantumvibe.com.
All right, let's go to your calls and thoughts. We can talk more about these tactics too. Make people hate protesters here in a moment. But first, Hank is listening in Florida. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Hank.
Hello, this is Hank.
Yes,
Hank. Last time I called in is H. Reardon, so just to let you know.
Welcome. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, I wanted to talk about activism. First of all, in that video, I don't consider burning what essentially is a cake decoration as activism.
No, it's not activism.
Why not? When you put it on video, it's even more activism at that point because then more people have a chance to see it. We're talking about the video of the flag burn going on right now at freekeen.com.
What those things really are they're intended to be used as cake decoration. But anyway,
they're flags. They're U.S. flags. Why? I mean, is it not a flag because it's 1 inch by 2 inches or whatever?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Okay.
But what I really wanted to talk about was I like the Albert J. Knox idea of activism, which is he said that the people you want to reach are people that he referred to as the remnant, the people who really understand the nature of the state and society.
I agree. That's who I want to reach.
Those are the minority of people. So you can't really focus on trying to convert the masses.
Totally agree.
What you really want to do is you're going to reach what he called the remnant.
Yep, I'm on board with you completely. That is really the goal of a lot of my videos. Some people seem to be very confused by this, like, oh, this is going to offend people. Well, I want to, like you're saying, the remnant, these people who are out there who love freedom, who understand what it is, but don't know that we're here, that don't know that the Free State Project exists, that don't know that there's a movement of thousands of people who love freedom who are all moving to New Hampshire in order to get active so we can achieve liberty in my life, in our lifetime. I want those people to know we exist. And doing meaningful stuff like, you know, Derrick J's Victimless Crime Spree and other great videos that have come out of Keene, New Hampshire, and now Manchester with Shire Dude and Rob Mathias and those folks out there. Doing those kind of videos, I think, reaches those folks. And so I'm on board with that, Hank. Thank you. Anything else you want to share?
No, that's pretty much what I wanted to call about. And, you know, I think that you shouldn't worry about offending people because somebody's going to be offended by anything you do.
Absolutely, and I thank you for the call tonight. And, you know, there are people out there who've been wringing their hands about activism that could be considered offensive for years here in New Hampshire. This is, you know, I'm sure going to cause more of it.
Well, it's easier than doing your own activism.
Well, there's that, right? So normally one of the responses is, well, maybe you should show us how to do it better, how to do activism better.
Just a critic.
The thing is, even if they do go out there and they do some political action or whatever, which for the most part is ineffective because it takes forever to change the political system.
Comparing burning toothpicks to political activism, you call political activism ineffective.
It's ineffective at attracting people here when you just go out and
is true. Now, I'll give you that it's very difficult to get you. It takes a long time to get that political stuff going, and you can't produce
it's not a fast, easy video.
Yeah. You can sort of use some of the political stuff as like B-roll.
We've made videos. I mean, don't get me wrong. Chris Cantwell has a great series, the Anarchist Lobbyist series, or the Anarcho Lobbyist, which features me and Cantwell and Daryl going and testifying from a principled perspective in front of these political panels. So I think that's valuable. And keeping it short, of course, is important. So having excerpts instead of some 2-hour long testimony session at the State House. So I think there are ways to recruit people here through the political process. But doing stuff like the flag burn attracts a different kind of person, somebody who appreciates more, I guess, in the streets style activism, outside the system style activism. And I'll do it all, right? So I'll do whatever I can to achieve more freedom. But the point is, there are people who believe that they can be successfully unoffensive by doing inside the system stuff. And the thing that those people don't realize is that as soon as they start to actually have an effect, as soon as you actually start to roll back bad government programs and, you know, eliminate government involvement in people's lives, then the offense will happen. Then people will start to rise up against you. Then, and already this has happened, by the way.
And when they do rise up against you, then they will post your flag-burning video to show what an a-hole you are.
Oh, well, they'll have all kinds of other things.
They sure will.
They're going to be upset that you're going to be taking away
their
government benefits.
They will. You're right. I'm not going to claim that that's not true.
You're going to be cutting their government jobs. They're going to be upset that you're going to be cutting their government
pensions. You hate children.
And all of that is going to come out, and they're going to try to use it against you politically. Some people, Mark, have even been targeted in other ways for running for politics. I remember, I think it was Sue Jeffers in Minnesota. She was a libertarian running for governor, if I'm recalling correctly. Anyway, all of a sudden, the government inspectors, she was like a restaurateur as well, mm-hmm. right? So she is an activist for the libertarians, and she runs a restaurant. Well, because she was relatively successful as far as like getting some attention for her libertarian campaign, what do you know? After years of being a successful business person, government inspectors show up at her business and find all manner of different supposed violations of her business. And maybe that was just a total coincidence, or maybe they targeted her because she had a chance politically. She didn't win, ultimately, because you know she ran as a libertarian, and that almost never wins. But nonetheless, she at the very least had them scared that she'd get people thinking, and so they targeted her for retaliation. So people that think that politics is some sort of safe zone just don't have success politically, generally, because once you start having success, newspaper editorials come out against you. We've had that happen already here in New Hampshire because Free Staters mm-hmm. are getting elected. There are blogs here in New Hampshire that hate on the Free State Project, from not just because of what goes on in Keene, but also because of the political successes. They actually had an article that came out. It was at Granite State Progress, I think. this, you know, one of these activists.
When they claim they're making progress, they're probably not.
They outed as many of the Free Staters as they possibly could during the last election, and they had an article about who the Free Staters are and who the supporters of the Free Staters are that were running for office. Further, they even certain group, I don't know if it was Granite State Progress, but some group of haters created a flyer, a hit piece flyer that was sort of a cut, sort of like an interchangeable flyer where they could change out the name and the photo of the person, basically, mm-hmm. and maybe a few facts about them. And then the rest of the flyer was just sort of generic hatred towards the Free State Project. And they sent these flyers out and tried to badmouth, essentially, and slather with hatred these political candidates who were just running for state rep and they're Free State Project participants. Now, by the way, some people who were hit with those flyers won. Others who were hit with the flyers didn't win. So you could argue that they didn't really have an effect, but maybe they did. Maybe they actually had an effect of getting people out to vote for them. Because the hit piece flyer, people
that
look
could,
at that.
But and you can't buy that kind of, you know, that kind of promotion.
Well, that's what I'm saying, right? So the activists who were running didn't have to pay for that printing job. They didn't pay to distribute
it. How many
it.
Of
they
them had
burned, the
burned flags before they had run? Zero.
None of them.
Right, none of them. And this isn't about doing activism or not doing activism. This isn't about what kind of activism works and what kind of activism doesn't work. This is about good sense and knowing that flag burning is going to make people very
take
angry.
Take it from the king. 855
refer to me as your majesty.
855-450-FREE is our toll-free number here. We'll talk about more ways that people are tricked into hating activists, hating protesters. From crack.com. Also, your calls are welcome. You can join us via Skype. The Skype username is lrn.fm or Free Talk Live coming up.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, zog.ninja, code FTL.
For over 75 years, Geico's kept an eye on the future, keeping customers happy with things like 24/7 customer support and emergency roadside service. And to prove it, here's one of our commercials from over 75 years ago.
At Geico, we promise to always find innovative new ways to serve you. In fact, we're so innovative, in 75 years, they'll listen to this old radio commercial and think, wow, they were innovative.
Wow, we are innovative.
Geico, saving people money for over 75 years.
We've all heard the news stories. Another shooting. And they're getting worse. That's why Infidel Body Armor introduces Infidel Fridays. Exclusive 24-hour insider deals to save you money and possibly save your life. Make it a favorite when you log on to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Then be sure to visit each and every Infidel Friday to get special insider pricing, but for 24 hours only. That's InfidelBodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Here's a breaking medical legal alert. Attention, users of the diabetes drug Actos. If you or a loved one has taken Actos, then developed bladder cancer, or if a loved one has died from bladder cancer after taking Actos, you may be entitled to significant financial compensation from the pharmaceutical giants who made these drugs. Our experienced attorneys are dedicated to help you get the money you're entitled to, but time may be running out on this opportunity. So you must call today. The information is free. There are no fees unless we win your case. If you or a loved one has developed bladder cancer or something worse after taking the diabetes drug Actos, call right now and learn your legal rights. This is an advertisement not valid in all states. I am a paid non-attorney spokesperson. Call the Tort Attorneys 24/7 right now. 800-430-7924. 800-430-7924. That's 800-430-7924.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Now more Free Talk Live. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That allows you to join us and talk about anything that might happen to be on your mind. With you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Derrick A.
And Mark.
And don't forget, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Do you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live? Whether you agree with Ian, Mark, Derrick J., it doesn't really matter. If you love freedom, if you love the ideas of liberty getting out there as far and as wide as possible, there's nobody else doing it at the level that Free Talk Live is. There's nobody else, at least in audio entertainment, doing it like this. And you can help us do it more effectively by joining the AMP program for $5 a month. You will get access to perks like special things like the AMP-only podcast, the AMP-only phone lines, the AMP-only Facebook group, and more. Plus, that $5 a month goes to help us, again, market the program, advertise Free Talk Live to new radio stations, and get the ideas out there into people's ears so they can consider them and maybe change their mind. So go to amp.freetalklive.com, A-M-P, amp.freetalklive.com. As we continue with your calls and thoughts, let's go to Dick. He's in Anchorage, Alaska. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick J., and Mark. Hello, Dick.
Thank you, gentlemen, for taking my call. I just wanted to talk about something briefly that you brought up last night on your program about, I believe it was Mark's son, Jack.
Yeah.
Swimming in a pool, and whether or not, basically, you were reading on a forum that there was a rule a lot of people believed, and this is a rule that I believe, but you guys really challenged me last night, my belief of it, that whenever you're swimming in a body of water, you should be supervised.
Meaning as an adult or just as a child?
Both.
Okay.
And I think that you had a really interesting case with your son in particular, and the, considering the size of the pool, it being just a little bit over a kiddie pool. So I do think that you really challenged my belief there. And I just finished the podcast, and I've been pondering it for a minute. But just to give you an idea of my background, I was a lifeguard all through high school. I'm a very strong swimmer, and it's something that I have experience with. I would say that the reason supervision is important in a pool or a body of water, let's say, as opposed to, let's say, if your child is just playing outdoors on dirt, is the type of injuries that are likely to happen if they're on land. You know, they fall, they can break their arm, they can break their leg. There's not really, supervision is not necessarily going to prevent that necessarily. And of course, we can think of a million examples where it would and where it wouldn't. But just for an example of kids on the monkey bars and let's go and falls, there's not much you could have done to stop that.
Right.
As an observer.
Makes sense.
On the contrary, if it's in a pool and some injury happens, and again, I don't think, you know, in a waist-high pool, there's much risk of something happening, but if they go under, then that is when observation is, you know, they're not going to get injured until they drown, and then that's kind of a worst-case scenario, and if you don't act within that first, you know, that very
minute,
small time frame, that's when, that's why I would say supervision is important. So I think that's what most people on the forum you mentioned were trying to get at. But I wouldn't say it necessarily has to be adult supervision.
Yeah, the difficulty is there that I'm just not going to have another kid to watch this one.
What about the dog? Maybe you could get the dog out there. It could come running like Lassie.
Yeah, that's right. We can teach.
Well, I said that'd be better than nothing. I'd trust the dog to watch your kid over the government. So there you go.
That's probably not a bad true.
Idea. Well, one thing I'd like to say about I was a lifeguard. I was certified as a lifeguard. I actually never employed as one. For certified advanced lifesaver, I think was what the Red Cross certification was that I got.
CPR and that kind of thing.
It's more than that, yeah. But yeah. That was the heart saver. That was part of the lifesaver card. But I'm a fireman now, and I can tell you that firemen, there's a class of firemen that's just crazy about fire. They just hate it. You know, they don't like candles. I'm in this class. You know, they don't like candles. They don't like, you know, open flames of any sort. And, you know, oftentimes, for one, I have to burn brush at my house, and the guys that you know are on the fire department also tend to be the fire warden to pass out these the pieces of paper that give you a fire permit. So they don't want to pass them out because fire's bad. They've spent their whole lives fighting fires and trying to stop things from burning. Now I have to pass out a piece of paper so that you can burn something. This is ridiculous. And so to some extent, of the responses I saw, often you'd find somebody say, I was a lifeguard. And I wonder whether they're, you know, a little hypersensitive. You know what I mean?
Well, I know what you mean. And I would say that's true. But in my experience as a lifeguard, because I was employed for 4 or 5 years in high school and I guess the first year of college, the injuries that I treated, I never helped it save anyone from drowning. So for me, I think it's a statistical anomaly. I think that when it happens, it's you know, it's generally fatal if you don't have the supervision.
You didn't even pull the big hook out on the side and pull some kid in from the, you know, middle of the pool? Nothing?
You know, there was one instance where a child fell in and I jumped in and I did save her. But it was a situation where I don't believe that they would. I think they could swim and they were fine somewhere. They just got nervous.
Yeah.
There was a situation before I was a lifeguard when I was younger, where a friend of mine actually was beginning to drown. And interestingly enough, it was one of our friends who saved him and not the lifeguard, which is another point. Because I remember you guys had mentioned some people said as long as there's a lifeguard there, it's okay. I would say the lifeguard is not as important as having a friend there watching you, because if a lifeguard is watching 20 people and then there's 19 a second later, it's going to be hard for anyone to notice that.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Let alone, you know, I was 16 and in high school I wasn't really focused. I wasn't necessarily the best lifeguard, you know. And just remember, most of those lifeguards are kids. So it's kind of a misnomer to say you need adult supervision.
Yeah, they're not much more than adults, not much more than kids. So first off, you said you jumped in for the kid. I'd like to say the best thing to do for people listening, I understand you made the decision you made at the time, and I'm sure it was the right one. But you don't go in the water with somebody who's drowning. You get the, you know, if there's a hook or something on the side that you can throw to them, that's a better way to go.
Oh, absolutely.
Dick, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate your perspective and the thoughts. Let's talk to Michael in Missouri. You're on Free Talk Live, Michael, with Ian, Derrick, Jay, and Mark.
Thank you for taking my call.
No, go ahead. That's what we do. Your thoughts, please.
Okay, Ian, I have a couple questions for the both of you.
Well, there's three of us here, but yes, go for it.
Okay, I'm sorry.
No worries.
Okay, number one, I don't listen regularly to the show, but I have listened before.
Great.
And I'd like to know if you were beginning to buy Bitcoin, who you would buy it from. Kind of what's the easiest way to do that? And then my other question is, if you really would like to move to New Hampshire and be a part of the Free State Project, would you wait till you have a job to do it, or would you just come on up and then kind of figure that if you're a good guy, you know, a hard worker, a smart guy, you can probably find a job and a way to live?
Oh, excellent questions. First one's really easy, expresscoin.com. It is fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive to get Bitcoin through ExpressCoin. As long as you can cut them a check or send them a money order, they will send you Bitcoin or even Litecoin or Dogecoin, and you can do it from the U.S. or Canada, expresscoin.com. If you're outside of the U.S. or Canada, One of the other ways to do it is to find somebody, you know, physically, locally, that, you know, might be willing to sell you some Bitcoin. That can be, you know, it can be easy or hard depending on how many people like that there are. But I would say ExpressCoin.com is a pretty darn easy way to do it. And you can even get up to $40 worth of it for no fee, no transfer fee, if you use code FTL. So that hopefully takes care of that. Also, for new people to Bitcoin, go to weusecoins.com to learn more about the technology, because we're just sort of glossing over it here. It's a decentralized currency not issued by any government or bank. The other question is really important regarding, you know, New Hampshire. Of course, the Free State Project trying to attract 20,000 people here. And people have come at this from a different approaches. Some people have thrown caution to the wind. They have taken, you know, what little money they have and, you know, got in their car and put their life's possessions in there and came up here and they made it work. Other people who've tried that have failed miserably. So, you know, it just depends. Would it make more sense? Would you feel more comfortable if you could nail down a job before you moved to New Hampshire? Absolutely. I mean, if that's a possibility, it wouldn't hurt to look into that. But that said, there have been people who have also, you know, done some saving, maybe saved 6 months worth of living expenses or whatever, and then have made the move. That way they still feel comfortable moving without a job. And then they know they're going to have a little bit of a buffer of time in which they can kind of get settled in, get unpacked and hit the streets and start looking for work. If you want to start looking for work in New Hampshire before you move to New Hampshire, one of the most popular things I hear about is to get a phone number based in New Hampshire. So when you're applying, you're putting your number down on job applications, it's got that 603 area code. People in New Hampshire recognize that. That's going to possibly keep you in the stack of options as opposed to, you know, a myriad of applications who might be coming in from outside of New Hampshire. But if you'll stand by, Michael, we'll come back with more, maybe get Derrick J. and Mark's opinion on this as well, because it's an important question. You know, what's the best way to move here? It's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, June 15th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.97 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,180 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $236. Antiwar.com reports Kurdish YPG forces are advancing this weekend against the Islamic State-held town of Tel Abyad, a primary route for the Islamic State capital of Raqqa to the Turkish border, and are threatening to cut off the key supply route for the Islamists. YPG officials are confirming coordination with the U.S. military on the attack and several airstrikes carried out against the Islamic State forces in the town, the number of which is said to be growing as civilians flee the area towards the Turkish border. Islamic State still controls the town and the border road, but Kurdish officials say they believe it is only a matter of time before they take the area, a move which itself threatens to fuel more Turkish anger about U.S. government's close alliance with Kurdish forces in Syria. Turkey has complained that the U.S. is allied with Kurdish factions like the YPG, which are considered terrorist groups in Turkey, and fears Kurdish growth along its border threatens to ignite a new secessionist war among Kurds inside Turkey. If nothing else, it is saddling the region with tens of thousands of new Arab refugees, as the Kurds are accused of chasing the Arabs out of the regions liberated from the Islamic State. Given how important Tel Abyad is to the Islamic State, it is unthinkable that the town will fall easily to the YPG advance, and even with U.S. air support, this is likely to be a protracted battle for control over the border crossing, one which the Islamic State will bring as many fighters as necessary to hold. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports representatives of the United States and Venezuela met in a high-profile summit in Haiti over the weekend to mend diplomatic ties. According to media reports, Thomas Shannon, a counselor to the U.S. Secretary of State, met with Chairman of Venezuela's National Assembly, Diosdado Cabello, on Saturday. The meeting lasted for about 90 minutes and was facilitated by the Haitian president. It was not immediately disclosed whether any progress was made or how much during the summit. Word of the summit was revealed on Twitter, where Venezuelan officials addressed the meet and said the efforts there were aimed at thawing the nation's icy approach to one another. Earlier this year, Venezuela accused the United States of plotting a coup to overthrow President Nicolas Maduro. In turn, Washington labeled the South American Republic a security threat.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports talks on ending a deadlock between Greece and its international creditors broke up in failure on Sunday, with European leaders venting their frustration as Athens stumbled closer towards a debt default that threatens its future in the euro. European Union officials blame the collapse on Athens, saying it had failed to offer anything new to secure the funding it needs to repay 1.6 billion euros to the International Monetary Fund by the end of the month. Greece retorted it was still ready to talk, but that EU and IMF officials had said they were not authorized to negotiate any further. Someone close to the talk said, "This is very disappointing and sad. It was the last attempt to bridge our differences, but the gap is too large. One can discuss a gap, but this is an ocean." Both sides acknowledged that the talks lasted less than an hour, although even here accounts differed. Greece put the length at 45 minutes. EU officials put it at half an hour. Last Friday, Greek Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras had indicated he would accept painful compromises on demands for austerity and reform in return for debt relief. But the Commission said after the talks, which also involved the European Central Bank, that the Greek proposal remains incomplete. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The FAA has issued a reminder that any plane can crash and kill you. Deputy FAA Administrator Serena Grant.
This year, there will be more flights than ever. Any one of them could blow up in the middle of the sky without warning. That's why we're asking all Americans to tell their families that they love them before taking off.
The agency also released a list of important questions to ask yourself or your seatmate during your flight, including, should the wing be doing that? What is that whirring noise? And do all planes shake this much? They're reminding passengers that even the smallest amount of turbulence could mean you're headed toward a sudden explosive death. While hurtling through the sky at unimaginable speeds in a steel coffin can feel like gambling with your life, the FAA says there are ways to regain the illusion of control.
If you're worried about crashing, why not switch your flight at the last second? It might just save your life. Or kill you, depending on which plane crashes.
And for those who aren't flying this holiday, the FAA has reminded everyone that a plane could fall out of the sky right on top of you at any moment.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. We launch into the third hour here. The toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We have Skype as well. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. And joining you in studio, you've got Ian.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
And we're going to go right back into your calls and thoughts. We had Michael on the line in Missouri. He was asking a question about moving to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. Derrick J., what is the Free State Project for our listeners just tuning into the show?
The Free State Project is an idea, the idea to move 20,000 liberty-loving people to the same geographic location to get active for liberty in our lifetime, whatever that means.
Right, and there are currently over 16,000 people, getting closer to 17,000, who have signed up for this.
Right, and so it does mean something different to everyone, so people do different forms of activism. But yeah, about moving here, people have taken all different kinds of strategies. When I moved here, I did what you had recommended, having a few months savings, a plan to get a job once I moved here. But I was 21 when I moved here, so I didn't have a family and kids. And
made it easier to pick up and go, right?
Right. So I had very few responsibilities weighing me down. For someone who is a little bit older, I would want to be more prudent in my planning and make sure that I do have a job lined up, because the last thing I would want is to run out of that 6 months savings or whatever I've got and then be at the end of my rope and say, yeah, sorry, everyone, it was nice meeting you, but I've got to pack up and go home now.
Yeah, this is the question that I would ask. Mike?
Yeah, Michael's here.
Do you have a career currently, or you just kind of do jobs?
No, I have a career, and the thing about it is my career is pretty high profile. I mean, people know who I am, but it's through it's very subsidized through a state government, to be honest with you. I'm not going to tell you what I do, but
governor?
No. Let's just say
I was just teasing you. You don't have to even, you know, give anything.
And so anyway, I don't have any children either. And I love freedom. You know, I love the thought of never violating anyone else's property rights. And I always try to offer value to everyone, not just, you know, relative to property rights, but just, you know, within interactions I have with them. And, you know, I wouldn't be able to probably work in the field I am up there, but that would be okay, you know. If I had to work at a thrift store or something for a little while until I could figure out something better, you know, I could do that. But I just kind of wanted to, you know, get some information on it, because I don't have you guys on the radio around here, but I can find you online, and I've listened to you more than any other radio program.
Thank you. I think the people who are willing to, you know, just work, the people who are not as choosy about what they have to do, they feel like they have to have a certain job and a certain profession, those are the people who are more likely to find something sooner, right? Like, if you're coming up here willing to just take anything that's available, well, there's always some sort of retail job available in New Hampshire. The economy is actually pretty good. The unemployment rate here in New Hampshire is one of the best in the entire country. So I think it's doable. In fact, Derrick J., you got, what, a job or two within about a week or so?
I got two jobs within 2 weeks.
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah, my advice would be if you're willing to work for something like $10 an hour, thereabouts, is that I'd just go ahead and take the risk of coming on up. Now, Ian?
I think it's a good idea to have some savings, right? Not just.
Oh, it's a good idea to have savings. Yeah. But you know, you should. He has a job currently.
You're talking about the risk of not having a job immediately when you say the risk, as right. opposed to just flying off the handle and coming up with $2.
I think that my experience is that people that move up here that want a job, and admittedly, that's a pretty big qualification, because some people that really don't, in my estimation, want a job, will claim, yes, I would like a job.
Or they'll claim to be looking, but when you ask them how many applications did you put in within the last week, they won't answer.
Right. Yeah. So, you know, I think it can be, I'm not going to ever promise anyone that everything's going to be fine when they move up to New Hampshire, because that would be a ridiculous thing to promise somebody. But my estimation would be is if I was taking the risk for myself and I had a small amount of savings that I could go without, you know, I could switch from one job to another, my expectation would be that I would be able to find a job within 2 or 3 weeks with relative ease, as long as you're just not caring what kind of job it is.
Yes, sir. Thank
Michael,
you so much.
Anything else? Thank you, man, for the call tonight.
No, sir.
I appreciate it. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. Maggie is in Arizona, and of course, you can bring up anything you want. This is Free Talk Live. Go ahead, Maggie. Oh, and she is now no longer there. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. You may join us there by sending a friend request or contact request to lrn.fm. That's our Skype username. Once we see that request come in, we will approve it. And then once that is approved, you will be easily able to call us on Skype, and you'll sound great compared to being on the phones. So feel free to join us there at Skype username lrn.fm. So we've also got to talk about more of these ways that people trick you into hating protesters. And Derrick J., you're also excited about an upcoming movie that is going to be featuring Bitcoin, at least in one portion of it. So we'll talk more about that, too. Dax, though, is with us first in Dallas, Texas. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick J., and Mark. Hello, Dax.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Go ahead. Good. We're doing great.
So we're moving up to New Hampshire in August.
Wow, woo! Congrats. Really? How exciting.
It was simple. We both were good employees, and our employer respects us, and we just told them we want to move to New Hampshire, and we'd still like to work with you, but if not, then that's okay, we're going.
Mm-hmm.
And both of us, they let us go remotely.
So wait, y'all work for the same company, or you work for two different companies?
Two different companies.
Nice.
She's in marketing, I'm in drafting.
That's so cool. I mean, you would have never have known unless you asked, right? And I mean, a lot of people might not even think to ask about this.
Yeah, and if you can possibly do your job at your house, why couldn't you move to New Hampshire and do it at your house?
Now, is this going to affect your income? Because New Hampshire does not have an income tax.
No, well, Texas doesn't either.
Okay, terrific.
But so it's the same thing. We're both moving the same salary.
Does Texas have a sales tax?
Yeah.
So you'll at least be saving some money that way once you spend your paycheck.
Well, property taxes are pretty high.
You'd have to ask what the property taxes are. I mean, I've got to say that I pay more in taxes in New Hampshire than I did in Florida.
We looked at it. It was it's done, the percentage wise is done differently, but it's almost even par.
Wow.
Okay.
Wow.
Yours says like 0.2 and ours says 22, but it's just it's 1,000 versus 100.
Yeah.
The way they count it, so it's like the same thing. So no big change there.
Well, there are ranges, by the way, just so people know. 0.2 or whatever is probably on the mid to lower range of New Hampshire's taxes. There are like 0.3 or 3%.
I'd say it's pretty much par for the course unless you hit a few major places.
Like Keene. Keene is awful.
Right. Well, Keene is one city.
It's one of the worst of taxes.
Yeah, it absolutely
Berlin,
is.
Berlin may be more of a higher rate, but the property values are in the tank there, so you're still not paying very
much. You're
probably
going to pay less. Yeah.
What kind of freedoms are you hoping to enjoy in New Hampshire that you don't have in Texas?
Just the movement, really. I'm here looking for something to do. I know there's things recently, but I'm just looking for all the different groups to hang out with and liberty-minded people to be involved with.
Well, you're going
to
get that in spades, no doubt about it. And the community here is really one of the best reasons to move to New Hampshire. The Liberty community is unmatched. It's unparalleled out there. There's nothing else that even comes close to the size and the scope, the depth of this community here. And so you said you're arriving in August, Dax?
Yeah, we'll make it to the last weekend of Pork Fest.
Woo!
We're meeting up with Mark Horton that Monday and Tuesday. So.
Oh, yay. Wow. So we'll get to meet you this coming next week then.
Yeah, the last weekend of Pork Fest.
Very cool. Make
Friday,
sure you stop by the studio and say hello to us. And Dax, thanks for the call. It's very exciting plans. Thank you again. Always great to hear from people who are planning to make this move. This is real. I mean, there really are people coming here. Every month there's the New Movers Party in Manchester where at least six, if not a dozen, new people will be there. And then, of course, there's dozens more who are there to welcome them. And, of course, it's important to point out that if you're going to be moving and you've got stuff that you're moving up with you, you let people know in advance. You go, like, on the Free State Project group on Facebook or on the Free State Project Housing Forum and let folks know, hey, we're coming up. We're moving into X town at X date at X time. And then, you know, people will show up and help you move in. When Taryn Lupo moved up, a dozen of us came out to help him move in. We had a full moving truck unpacked in 30 minutes. It's Free Talk Live. There's more coming up here in moments.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO? MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Quantitative easing, unemployment at depression levels, Europe financial system falling apart, China getting out of U.S. treasuries. At the end of 2008, the time of TARP, the national debt was at $11 trillion, gold trading around $850 per ounce. Close to 2012, the national debt exceeded $16.4 trillion, gold doubled to $1,600 per ounce. The $20 trillion threshold for the national debt is inevitable. Politicians in Washington have a ferocious appetite for spending and stimulus. What's worse, a printing press to finance. 100 years ago, we had a gold standard to limit this madness, but now you have to adopt your own gold standard. Don't be fooled with paper promises. Get Midas Resources 10 Reasons to Buy Gold free by calling 800-686-2237. Understanding the gold and silver market may be the only insurance you could have to avoiding the next economic crisis. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order your free copy. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Pure Life Water, helping you drink better and live better by providing a zero-calorie alternative to sugary drinks. Visit us at nestle-purelife.us. When kids are playing, they often don't want to stop to keep hydrated. So send them out with a bottle of water and encourage them to take frequent drink breaks or call them inside for a quick sip. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Now we're back with Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. Mark, you are doing your damnedest to keep that crown on the entire show.
I like it.
It is causing you some difficulty with the headphones. You need to make some kingly headphones.
I need earbuds.
Yeah, well, you can get some of those, although getting earbuds with a longer cable is a challenge. You have to get an extension cable.
Maybe his head's been growing tonight.
I bet that's the case. It's Ian, Derrick, Jay, and Mark in the studio, and of course you can join us here on the phones. 855-450-FREE. We still have a lot to talk about. Your calls come first, though, and want to let you know about Fort Galt. Mark, what is it?
Well, Fort Galt, it's an idea, foremost. The idea is to get together people down in Chile, folks that are entrepreneurs, freelancers, young professionals, small business owners, have them live together in a complex, kind of like a condominium complex, but you really are only buying a small area. Their smallest unit is $10,000, and it's basically a room, you know, that has a bed and a desk in it, but that has common areas. So they've got, you know, bathrooms and kitchens and restaurants and coffee shops and these sorts of things in these common areas. And it's an interesting idea. The idea is to get the synergy of these dynamic people together in one place and to see what they come up with. Also, there when you can rent out your room when you're not there, so you could potentially make some money on the deal. It's fortgalt.com, F-O-R-T-G-A-L-T, fortgalt.com. Check it out. They've got really great videos, a really great website. It's all worth doing the research for. I think you'll be impressed. Fortgalt.com.
All right, we're going to try Maggie again. She's back on the line here. Maggie, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick, Jay, and Mark. Go ahead.
Hi, gentlemen. How are you?
Welcome.
Hello.
Doing great. What's on your mind?
So, we live in a very little town in northeastern Arizona, and my dog is being put to death. We're on appeal right now for being dog at large.
No.
Oh, my.
What is dog at large?
Meaning loose?
Dog at large basically means that they were not on a leash or contained within a fence. And in the lovely county that I live in, is even if they're on your property, you can get a ticket for that.
So when I let my dog out my door to go to the bathroom and she isn't inside of a fenced-in area and doesn't have a leash on, she's subject to death.
In Arizona.
In my county. Yeah. Well, right
I do
now,
this every day.
That would be, if you had my neighbors, yes, that would be how it is.
Well, Maggie, thank goodness the cops didn't show up and shoot your dog. Just preempt the trial.
Yeah, I mean, we're grateful for that. We do have some very nice law enforcement gentlemen here. But the issue is she is being used as a pawn for about 24 months. We have been battling a rogue HOA. We are the does
homeowners
not say that
association.
We belong to the yes.
Okay.
And you know, I mean, we'll get right down to the point. Is that I'm a white girl married to a black boy with three biracial children.
And you think that's what the reason is? You think that's the reason?
Well, it's a huge part of the reason.
Okay.
Two weeks after being there, one of the neighbors walked up and said, "Oh, I see we let the enners in the neighborhood now."
Oh, man.
Whoa.
I almost went to jail, but you know what? My awesome guy, he just looked at him and said, "Yeah, they let us out of the woodshed every once in a while," and kept watching the dog.
Wow.
You know? Yeah. But my children have had to endure being called half-breeds, and I've been spat upon and called an inner lover.
In front of them? In front of your children? People, adults do this to and in front of young children.
We're talking blue-haired mafia here. We're not talking adults. We're talking people old enough to be my grandparents.
Yeah, they got nothing to lose, right? Why don't you give them some lip back? You ever get nasty with the old folks?
You know what? It's not... You try not to. You try to take the higher road.
Right.
But when we moved in, there is still, you know, some debate about who said what. But our home was burglarized just before we moved into it. And the neighbors around the neighborhood took the refrigerator, the washing machine, dryer, the dishwasher, plumbing fixtures, hot water heater.
Wow. What?
You know,
they took the refrigerator and the hot water heater?
I swear to God, I have all the court documents. I have the police report.
Are there some cameras in this place? I mean,
probably not.
That's moved in. Now. But they admitted to it. They admitted to it, and two or three of the items were returned.
Whoa.
And
how did they get caught?
Because they got turned in by the other neighbors.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, when we moved in, we obviously filed the police, you know, the owners that were there before we took ownership of it, we said, hey, you know, your property's gone. And long story short, they assigned over the victim's rights to us, and I took over being the champion to it because, you know, if it was, you know, and my children, my husband, me that had done that, our butts would be sitting in the slammer right now.
Yeah.
But the sheriff's department has recommended felony burglary. It's in the documents, black and white. You can look it up. You can call and ask for them. And the county attorney's office, the guy who does it, looked at me and said, I have 7 years to decide whether to prosecute or not.
Seven years.
So now,
he is running interference. He's running interference for these people.
Well, you know what? I didn't say that. You did.
Yeah.
But
that's what it sounds like. I mean, people playing games because they don't like you, and they're using whatever tools are at their disposal to make your life hell.
Well, and it's, you know, that's a huge part of it. The we have, you know, been almost 24 months of doing this whole battle thing.
Mm.
And we filed a lawsuit in January for $12.5 million because in...
Against whom?
Against the Homeowners Association and 64 other neighbors.
Wow. Oh, they love you.
Hey, tell me about the dog at large a little bit more, though. I'm curious about this. So dog at large, that doesn't mean your dog attacked somebody. It just means it wasn't on a leash.
Oh, no, actually, what they're saying is, see, I've had close to 20 tickets in the last year of dog at large.
Uh-huh.
It always happened when I'm gone, always happened when there's nobody at the house. And this particular day in September, I have four dogs. So if you know anything about dogs, you know if one dog gets out, they all get out.
Mm-hmm.
So Hannah Banana is 14, and she's a lab, so she has more spirit than you know other dogs that are her age. But she's a good girl. But when she was 18 months old, she was rescued and taken to a shelter in the valley, and it was discovered that her teeth had been filed down because they were going to use her in as a bait dog for a fighting ring.
Oh, what?
So her name was also on her collar was Tweaker 23. So she was rescued
dog. I got to say, I don't know much about dog fighting. I want to know more about this. If you'll hang on, Maggie, we'll talk more about dog at large and apparently being prepared to be a bait dog in a dog fight. 855-450-FREE. That sounds horrifying. 855-450-3733. You can join us here and you can bring up whatever's on your mind. This is Free Talk Live. Plus, you can join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateurs, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us on the radio waves here. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. Skype username's LRN.fm. Joining you tonight, Ian here.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
And don't forget to join us online over at freetalklive.com. If you like what we're doing, you can shop with us. Go and get your shopping taken care of. Maybe you want to get a fancy crown and outfit like Mark's been wearing here tonight in studio. What do you call that? Like a cape? A shawl?
Yeah.
What is that thing?
Yeah, it's a cape.
Is it called a cape when it's on a king? Though I would think there'd be another
word. I believe
word.
It's a mantle when it's
a
on a king.
Mantle. Oh. Ah. So I bet you can get stuff like that over at Amazon. I'm just guessing. Amazon's got almost everything. You want to go get your shopping done, go to shop.freetalklive.com. There's also a link to Walmart there if you want to try that one too. But Free Talk Live gets a cut when you go through those links at shop.freetalklive.com. As we go back to your calls and thoughts, Maggie is with us talking about a situation involving a neighborhood where she's been discriminated against because of the color of her husband's skin.
and their kids as well, facing very rude, racist comments by some elderly folks apparently in the neighborhood. Further, they have targeted their dog, the 14-year-old Labrador. There's actually four dogs, as you mentioned, Maggie, but the oldest one is 14. And you said that her teeth had been filed down when she was younger when you got her, because she was intended to be used as a bait dog in a dog fighting ring. What is a bait dog?
Well, you know that, Michael Vick, okay? Just think Michael Vick. I mean, and what happened at his house is exactly what Hannah was intended to be. She was intended to be when they had, there's big gambling money in dog fights, mm-hmm. Just like cock fights. When you have the prize rooster, you have the prize dog.
Right.
And if the dog cannot defend itself, then it's part of the practice. It's just like bringing the third string in on a football team and having the A team play the C team, and that's how they get better.
Oh, so so what you're saying is that a bait dog is a dog that is intended to lose. That this is a dog.
It's what they call a squash match in wrestling.
Yeah.
I have a definition from Wikipedia too. It says dog baiting is the setting of game dogs against a chained or confined animal for sport, and the dogs bite and tear to subdue the opposing animal by incapacitating or killing it.
So filing its teeth down would make it less able to defend itself.
It would be the one that was being attacked by the other dogs.
Okay.
Yes.
So how did it end up getting out of the house? I mean, you said this has happened multiple times.
You said you had like 40-something tickets.
Well, it's close to 20 tickets.
Okay.
But every time that we leave, see, when the geriatric squad robbed our home, they went in through the front doggy door because you could basically kick it open, reach up, and unlatch the door from the handle right there.
Okay.
So, you know, we had changed the locks and did everything, and we couldn't figure out how they kept getting in. Well, we discovered that they could kick in, after we read the police reports, they were just kicking in the doggy door and opening the door, and they would let one specific dog out. Well, generally, they would let our Charlie dog off the lead when we would have him outside. Now, Charlie is a German Shepherd Akita, and we had to take and have his collar welded to his tie down so that it would take them forever to get him off of it. They would have to either cut his collar or take the time to take the collar off of him and let him loose. So that stopped him and me getting tickets for him. So
what you're saying is, your neighbors who hate you because of presumably because of the race of your husband, they are letting your dog out. That it's not your dog just getting out on their own, that they have been going over purposefully to put you in a position of receiving tickets and making you look bad for letting the dog out.
Yes, and they always have a camera. They always have a camera. Well, this particular day, they said that these individuals said that she had jumped 3 feet up over the porch and 5 feet down, ran across the street, bit a little old lady on the arm and mauled her little poodle to death, then ran back across the street to our property, laid down underneath the pine tree in the sun, and just wagged her tail until animal control showed up and said, "She's a sweetheart," and then they turned her over because there was no physical evidence. There was no.
So the woman who was supposedly
hit on a dead dog?
The dog died 4 days later, but when animal control went down to talk to her, she said that the dog would live, but then the dog died 4 days later, and I still don't understand how my dog. The ticket is written for a shepherd with a red collar, a red shepherd with a red collar. And I have a yellow lab with a pink collar.
So now you're facing the confiscation and the murder of your dog over this ticket. Is that right? If you get found guilty in court, that's what's going to happen?
No. They already found me guilty.
Oh.
But all of the witnesses are the people that are named in the lawsuit that are, said to have felony burglary charges against them.
You
got to
get out of this place.
Yeah, this is a terrible place for you to live.
Yeah.
We would really, we like to sell it, but the HOA has put $16,000 worth of fraudulent liens on it.
Oh, no.
So we can't sell it. So we can't move. We can't
Why don't you go ask them to take the liens off? Hey, say, look, we'll sell it.
If you take the liens off. Not a bad idea. Maggie, good luck. Let us know how it goes. Appreciate the story tonight. It's just horrifying.
Wow.
Thank you for the call tonight. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. Shocking stuff. We'll continue here. Another call from Arizona. James is on the line in Phoenix. James, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick, Jay, and the King.
No disrespect to Maggie. I hate racists and confront them with all my verbal barrage that I would if they were my neighbors. Hmm. And I love the great state of Arizona. My dog has lived free as a bird his entire life and is alive and well and happy 16-year-old dog because he's never worn a leash. Or a collar. Yeah, but that was some very boring 20 minutes of radio, by the way. I could care less about her.
Well, I don't really care about what you have to say then either.
Everybody else,
thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE.
I learned something about Wit, is that he has a dog that's 16 years old that shows he has a heart.
I learned something about Wit. He got arrested for a DUI earlier, like about a week ago.
Oh.
Yeah, another one apparently. Toll-free number tonight's 855-450-FREE.
Should have let the dog drive.
He hasn't learned his lesson.
The best thing to do is for him to just drink and call Free Talk Live and spill vitriol all over the place.
Yeah. Nobody wants to hear if you didn't like the last phone call, Wit. Call about something relevant. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I think a lot of people can relate to that, having bad neighbors, frustrations with neighbors. I mean, lots of people have dogs out there. I think it's very relatable.
James always gets distracted. I feel a little bit bad because I know he has a point that wasn't that. You know, and he gets distracted about something. He's got to say it and before he gets to his point, but then it's too late.
But that's not what I called about.
Then it's too late.
Yeah.
Let's go to Nathan in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Nathan. And you're on via Skype. Go ahead. We have Nathan in Texas going once. Nathan in Texas going twice. Perhaps something is wrong with my Skype system here. We'll do a quick check with the audio. Looks like the audio is okay, so it's probably Nathan.
He's just got his microphone muted.
Yeah, that's half the time what will happen. Our toll-free number again is 855-450-FREE. Charlton is on the line in California. Charlton, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey there.
Hey.
Hey, I got a dog. You know what her name was? Truffles. And you know what happened to her? She ran out in the road and got hit by a car.
Sorry to hear
and
that.
I don't care. You know, I'm not going to sue anybody about it, but that's what happened.
Well, and I don't think you could sue somebody, right?
You can tell what's her name in Arizona that she should just relax.
Why should she relax? They're threatening to kill her dog.
Well, get a new one.
Well, I mean, that's an easy thing to say, but I mean...
Dogs are like members of the family, man. Yeah. I mean, I'm sure your dog meant a lot to you.
My dog was a member of the family, and I mourn her death every day.
But yours was something that was out of your control, right? A car hit your dog. It's not like that was done on purpose, probably.
No, she got out, and she got hit.
Right. That's life. It happens, and that's a bummer, and obviously you have to move on, and a good way to do that, and thanks, Charlton, for the call, a good way to do that is to get another dog, certainly. But in her case, she still can fight for her dog, who is still alive. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
It's the end of quarter clearance sale at Lumber Liquidators. We're North America's largest specialty retailer of hardwood flooring, and we've got 10 million square feet of top quality floors for as much as 77% less than other stores. Get over 200 styles of real pre-finished hardwood from just 49 cents, 40 styles of beautiful bamboo from $1.59, plus deals on popular American and European laminates and more from an incredible 39 cents. And pay no interest until 2017. Hurry, clearance sale's going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Moments remain, but there's just enough time for you. If you dial in now at 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. You can join us online anytime at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features waiting there for you. And don't forget to enjoy Derrick J's website at thederrickj.com. He does so many radio shows. He's got Cop Block Radio and Flaming Freedom and Freedom Fiends, and you're on Free Talk Live as well.
Yeah.
And you're going to be doing almost all of those live from the Porcupine Freedom Festival next week. So your chance to come up and observe the fun of Flaming Freedom in person, because it's a fun show to listen to, and it's even more fun in real life. At least the Liberty Forum episode was very, very good, so I expect this one's going to be even better, because at Porkfest, you get a good-sized audience. There were a spattering of people there at Liberty Forum, but it was late at night, and you know, other people were out kind of partying. At Porkfest, Flaming Freedom, Cop Lock, all these other great shows are going to be live. Those are attractions. Those are things that are actually, people want to go out and do that sort of stuff at Porkfest. So I don't imagine there will be less than a few dozen people in the room. And so it'll be a good crowd and should be a lot of fun. So come on up and join us at the Porcupine Freedom Festival starting Sunday and going through the entire week, Sunday through Sunday. It's the 21st through the 28th. And you can learn more about that at porkfest.com, P-O-R-C-F-E-S-T.com. We're going to give Nathan one more try here. I think that he has fixed his microphone problem, hopefully at least. Nathan, are you with us?
I believe so.
Yes, we have you. Go ahead.
Well, I'm glad that Mark's been promoted to king, but maybe he should be like an emperor or something.
Oh, don't emperor make his Marcus head any Augustus? Larger. Anyway, go ahead.
Well,
Your Majesty.
I wanted to talk about the Free Republic of Liberland.
Liberland, yeah.
There was a man interviewed from Liberland on the show yesterday.
Nicholas Nicolaisen.
Yes, and he said something about taxes, which I wasn't sure if I heard him correctly. He said there would be no taxes in the Liberland government.
It's constitutionally prohibited.
The Constitution cool. right now is in draft form. It is a crowdsourced constitution. It's available. I linked to it on our Facebook and Twitter yesterday, so you can see what it actually says. It's not been finalized yet, but as of right now, I haven't read it, so I'm taking his word for it.
I went to their front page and downloaded the Constitution.
Okay.
Glad I could say that because it's the 21st century now. And it does provide for a taxing authority. It says in section, I guess it's section 4.16, subsection 3, to lay and collect taxes provided for in the taxation bill for one or more of the following purposes only. And then it lists several things, including covering the expenses of the public administration, maintaining the internal security, and providing for the system of administration of justice. And I like this last one, securing and promoting the interests of the Free Republic of Liberland worldwide. So, you know, that's not a loophole you could drive a truck through or anything, right?
Yeah, sounds like one.
Well, so, I guess, I haven't read the whole thing. Did you read the entire Constitution?
I didn't read the entire Constitution.
Because he said that there was a segment in there that said that taxes would be voluntary, and so laying and collecting those taxes would be a voluntary exercise. But, you know, who knows what it's going to end up being like when it's all said and done.
It's not like governments follow their constitutions anyway, so who cares what it says?
Well, yeah, that's a good point. You'll probably like the section 2.3, though, right after no ex post facto laws. It says no law shall create victimless and or consensual crimes, and et cetera. I guess my point about it would be that when you trust a government to limit itself through a constitution, it's kind of like trusting a monkey paw to give you a wish, right? Mm. It's like no matter what you put in there, it's going to come back and bite you somehow, or it's going to turn out to be, hurt. You know, it's going to be bad in the future, right? Because if you and I wanted to put a plug in for Anatomy of the State. It's a book by Murray Rothbard, and he goes into this argument where if you look at things that are designed to limit governments, like constitutions, or he even says the divine right of kings, things like this that are intended to limit government become repurposed through the ruling class to actually promote government.
And, good points. Thanks, Nathan, for your call tonight. I appreciate it.
Yeah, that's true. But I mean, I don't know what else one can do. If we have a piece of land, what they call the terra nullius, this unoccupied piece of land, you have to sort of create a government in order for the other governments to recognize it.
That's what he was saying last night.
And then at that point, you compete with those governments for citizens. They don't have a lot going for them there at Liberland. And what they've staked their petard in is essentially freedom. And freedom means, you know, really, really low taxes or no taxes. I get that you have to have, you know, if you're going to have public property, you're going to have
to. Freedom means more than that. Freedom means the ability to do what you want so long as you don't, initiate force or aggression or fraud against another person. So it's great to not have taxes, but also it'd be nice to not have someone putting you in a cage for, let's say, having a plant or a chemical on you.
It certainly means more than that, but it means that. Also,
it is included for sure.
Yeah. And so, you know, they have to compete. Why would I go there if they suddenly decide, you know, we need lots more taxes? Mm,
yeah, exactly.
So, I mean,
because it's a swamp as is.
I would say that they do need to, figure out some way to survive on what they would call fees or something. Mm-hmm. Why would you use the terminology taxes in this circumstance? Call it an annual citizenship fee. I don't know. It would probably be superior to whatever it is that
if it's voluntary. I don't care. Then, you know, I wouldn't have a problem with paying for services on a voluntary basis.
All taxes are voluntary if you can leave and go someplace else. But the fact is there's essentially it's like the bully saying go to some other schoolyard and get beat up there by their bully.
Yeah, exactly.
So there currently isn't anything else. And if there was one little tiny place where you could go that didn't have this taxation thing, then it would be voluntary.
So Bitcoin has been on television in TV series as a sort of part of a plot. And now, Derrick J., you're excited about an upcoming movie that is also going to feature Bitcoin, like a Hollywood-level kind of movie? Like this is a major release?
Yes. MovieTickets.com, one of the largest movie ticket purchasing platforms in the U.S., now enables moviegoers to buy movie tickets with Bitcoin.
Whoa. Big deal, yeah.
At 985 theaters. So this is...
Whoa, this is huge news. I have bought tickets from MovieTickets.com in the past.
Yes, many people have.
Yeah.
And this is a story at Coindesk.com, but it's being reported on across the internet. The move was made possible through the integration with Bitcoin payment processor GoCoin. As a result, theater chains that use the credit card processing service offered by MovieTickets.com will be able to accept Bitcoin for any film offered.
Outstanding. So this isn't some sort of promo thing just for this one movie that's coming out called Dope. This is for anybody buying movie tickets. This is a big, big... I mean, to me, this is a big one because entertainment, you know, is something that people are they're very interested in, right? And so if people can buy their tickets with Bitcoin, that's another big notch in Bitcoin's favor.
That's right. GoCoin CEO Steve Beauregard indicated that this includes Regal Cinemas, the nation's largest theater chain with more than 500 locations. And holdouts notably include AMC Theaters, which itself boasts more than 300 locations in North America.
Holdouts meaning they're not included?
That's what it sounds like to me.
Yeah, it sounds like it's...
The promotion, as you mentioned, Ian, was inspired by the promotional strategy for Dope, the hit indie film that scored big at Sundance and earned high-profile celebrity fans from James Franco to Russell Simmons. So this movie...
What's it about?
From what I understand, it's about a group of teenagers. Part of the plot involves them selling ecstasy Dope. In exchange for Bitcoin on the internet.
Excellent. Well, I mean, you know, I hope it's real ecstasy because I would presume that it would be if they're selling it on the internet because if they're selling on
Reputation system.
Right, on the underground marketplaces like the Silk Road, you have reputation and bad sellers will get bad reputation and they'll be ousted by buyers who will not be interested in them anymore. When's this coming out? What's the release date?
Well, according to TheWrap.com, the film opens Friday to roughly 2,000 screens nationwide.
Wow.
And it's laced with references to iPhones, YouTube, and apps like Waze. But it's the digital currency Bitcoin that is arguably has the starring role in the comedy.
I'm betting you there's going to be a group of people going there from Porkfest, the Porcupine Freedom Festival. Sometimes people will go for a little carpool to a movie theater and do a little something outside of the campground. That sounds like it'd be a qualifier.
What do you think? Are people going to say that this is ruining the movement? Are they going to say that this is...
Oh, sure they will.
Promoting, you know,
Bitcoin. It's aligning Bitcoin with drug use, and this is bad for Bitcoin.
Oh, whatever. Hey, early in the film, one of the main characters says, quote, "I just read that money as we know it is dead. Soon the world is only going to buy and sell products using Bitcoins."
That's a great endorsement.
That's pretty cool.
I'm excited.
Yeah, I think it's going to be, it's great. I would not be one of those people saying that this is ruining the movement. I think this is awesome.
Well, I don't know if the movie theater in Lancaster, New Hampshire is aligned with movie tickets. I don't know how many...
2,000 screens?
It's
all of them.
I thought it was 985.
The movie is going to be playing at 2,000 screens.
Right.
And there are over 900 theaters that will accept Bitcoin.
That's awesome. And if movie tickets is doing it, then there's another one, Fandango. I bet you they'll be coming along
next
sooner rather than later.
Yep.
As a result, we'll see you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, freetalklive.com. And don't forget thederrickj.com for more of Derrick J. See you tomorrow, freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
Every day you make investment decisions.
When you do business with and hold U.S. dollars, you make an investment in the soundness of the moral philosophy and the potential longevity of the United States hegemony. People who claim a monopoly on violence around the world. If this is the investment that you want to make, please keep listening to LRN.FM. If not, stop using their currency. Use bitcoins. Get educated. We use coins.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, June 15th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.97 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,180 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $236. Antiwar.com reports Kurdish YPG forces are advancing this weekend against the Islamic State-held town of Tel Abyad, a primary route for the Islamic State capital of Raqqa to the Turkish border, and are threatening to cut off the key supply route for the Islamists. YPG officials are confirming coordination with the U.S. military on the attack and several airstrikes carried out against the Islamic State forces in the town, the number of which is said to be growing as civilians flee the area towards the Turkish border. The Islamic State still controls the town and the border road, but Kurdish officials say they believe it is only a matter of time before they take the area, a move which itself threatens to fuel more Turkish anger about U.S. government's close alliance with Kurdish forces in Syria. Turkey has complained that the U.S. is allied with Kurdish factions like the YPG, which are considered terrorist groups in Turkey, and fears Kurdish growth along its border threatens to ignite a new secessionist war among Kurds inside Turkey. If nothing else, it is saddling the region with tens of thousands of new Arab refugees, as the Kurds are accused of chasing the Arabs out of the regions liberated from the Islamic State. Given how important Tel Abyad is to the Islamic State, it is unthinkable that the town will fall easily to the YPG advance, and even with U.S. air support, this is likely to be a protracted battle for control over the border crossing, one which the Islamic State will bring as many fighters as necessary to hold. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports representatives of the United States and Venezuela met in a high-profile summit in Haiti over the weekend to mend diplomatic ties. According to media reports, Thomas Shannon, a counselor to the U.S. Secretary of State, met with Chairman of Venezuela's National Assembly, Diosdado Cabello, on Saturday. The meeting lasted for about 90 minutes and was facilitated by the Haitian president. It was not immediately disclosed whether any progress was made or how much during the summit. Word of the summit was revealed on Twitter, where Venezuelan officials addressed the meet and said the efforts there were aimed at thawing the nation's icy approach to one another. Earlier this year, Venezuela accused the United States of plotting a coup to overthrow President Nicolas Maduro. In turn, Washington labeled the South American Republic a security threat.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or